without further ado, the High Five Guys podcast.
High Five Guys.
Or is it just the High Five podcast now?
It's the High Five podcast.
Okay.
Yay.
The High Five podcast.
James, don't go far.
Oh, good.
So, we'll grab our seats with all of these extra chairs and say to the audience that there are some challenges going on. So we're going to need Lauren, Matt, Salsa, James, and Jenna.
Oh, wow! Oh!
Girl!
Yeah.
I want to sit awkwardly at everybody.
I want to sit in this wooden chair that looks extra comfy.
Salsa, you get the cozy spot between Eric and Jason.
Right next to the booze.
Oh. That does look like a good spot.
I brought my own booze, Eric. I don't
Can
trust
I put
you.
Some of this in my coffee? Maybe.
No? What kind of podcast do you think this is?
I can't make this go any lower.
Oh, that's delightful.
You want to switch,
oh my
Jenna?
God, you brought me a new one?
I'm taller.
Hey, everyone. I'm Ray. Eric.
I'm Kayla.
And you're listening to the High Five Podcast, where today we are live at Die Laughing 2018.
Woo! Which means anything can happen.
Oh, anything God. Already has happened.
Yeah.
Lots of things happen.
Which means anything can happen.
Many things are left to happen.
So.
But I'm on your right.
All of this.
Just trying to get close to the mics at the moment because I have a lot of booze in the way.
Humble brag.
First world pro.
So I want to announce that we have some challenges going on. They're similar to challenges we've done in the past. For a $10 donation, you can add a host of the other podcast.
Wait.
So for this podcast, that would mean that you could add Salsa, Jenna, or James from AOM to join us. $10, they'll join us for 20 minutes. Or we have two past hosts. Matt is a former host of AON, and Lauren is a former host of High Five. And you can add them to either or both. $10 for 20 minutes. And we have a $250 matching grant going on right now.
Ooh. Yeah.
So your donations go twice as far.
We also have our lovely drink challenge. For a $20 donation, you can make one of us take a shot. For a $100 donation, we will all do a round.
Oh,
and we have brought things to inflict upon each other in these shots.
Wait, what?
And they will not be the most pleasant things.
No.
So please, if you're watching online or if you're here in the theater and want to donate to give us more time, then that would be appreciated. Go for it, Salsa.
Yes.
This isn't True Stone coffee, so it needs to be doctored.
Yeah. You know what is True Stone coffee?
What? Whoa. We have actual True Stone coffee?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, dude.
I have True Stone cold press.
Untis.
Oh, but I can't have ramchata.
That's your problem.
I can.
You can have sexy True Stone coffee.
God,
so this
crazy.
Is the first year we have done kind of a pre-donation thing for the challenges, and that means that currently we're starting off with me having 5 donations to be on AON.
Oh,
so that's an hour and 40 minutes.
And that's not even our whole show.
Lauren has 2 donations to be on High Five. So far, that's 40 minutes on this one. And 1 for AON.
Yay!
Matt has 1 for High Five and 6 for AON.
Yes! Sucker! Oh, my love.
He's got to be there the whole time.
Hello, my sweet
Babu.
So
do I.
And Jenna, James, and Salsa all have 1 for this podcast, so 20 minutes.
This is going to be the worst 20 minutes of your morning.
Oh.
But it can be
we're nowhere near the worst 20 minutes of your morning.
No, yeah.
We're already 5 in, so I've had... when did we start?
Now.
Oh. Yeah. What? Oh, I thought we already...
Now,
God
now
damn
that
it.
You mentioned it. So thanks.
God damn
I would
it.
Have taken more time.
So we have, as is tradition, we have some lovely drinks here from our own crappy genie, Ian.
Yeah.
Crappy Gene, comma, shallot.
Whoa. Crappy Gene is not my one.
He's just a guy who fronted
all of this booze.
This could probably go on for half the podcast.
Oh, yeah.
The JP 20 minutes at least.
I just took a picture of our view.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is it a lot of white lights? Because
it's a lot of white lights so and black space. Light. That's all we can see.
I feel like there's...
And yes, I'm posting.
There's a crappy genie and a flying squirrel. That's about as much as
I can
see.
Yeah, that's all I can see.
Oh, wait. No, there's the... Yep, this is a stair. All right, we're good.
Yeah. Wait. Eric? Who said that?
What? Yay!
Oh, fuck yeah. I can only see the first row, my bad.
Yeah.
Oh, man, can I point out why Lauren and I have been giggling like school children?
I mean, please do.
Turns out.
What?
Is accent day!
Yeah! Is accent day!
Welcome to the Hot Five Podcast!
Hey! This is certainly a lot better.
You will never hear a better accent day than we have for you.
Each accent day can only be better than previous accent day, because each time we have accent day, which is a holiday if you do not know, which occurs whenever it is declared. And each accent day, we've only had more accent days to better hone our accents.
That is true.
Much so like the eye laughing itself, we get better every year.
We're going to be nauseating.
Okay, so there's a comedian who talks about accents and how every accent is focused on a single letter. For example, the Bostonian accent, you focus on the R. You drop the R from wherever it is. He says for the Russian accent, you just put a Y in everywhere.
I feel like a lot of my life has been me putting a Y in places.
I feel like your life is just Y.
I feel like I need to point out that there is already a Y in everywhere.
Son of a bitch.
How much to buy me off of this podcast?
Eric, how much is it to buy a shot just for one person?
20.
I'm putting 20 down. I will put 20 in the thing. I want you to take a shot of something awful in front of you.
Yeah.
Do it right now. Yeah. I will pay 20 for you to do a shot right now.
Oh, so I get to pick. You're not going to inflict the AON stuff on me?
No, we'll do that later.
Yeah, that's coming.
I don't want you
that's
to pick, though. What booze is in front
Sugar,
of you
that's
right
gonna
now?
Happen.
That was a.
The booze that's in front of me right now, this?
Yeah, I can't see all of the booze.
That little baby?
What is that?
Oh.
All I see is a pile of back ends of booze bottles, so I can't pick anything.
Oh, those are like little jars of horror.
Little jars.
Are there jars?
Little jars of horror. Little jars of horror.
Whoa. Welcome, guys. It's fucking early.
Yeah.
I would like to point out, I think I may still hold the world's record for going from dead sleep to podcasting.
Yeah.
I think this is at least 3 years now.
Lauren, can I say it is a joy to share a podcast with you because you will always not only back up but also front every song cue I pick up.
Thanks.
Yeah.
To be fair, it's better from the opposite end of the bench like you are.
You should take a shot of one of the little jars of water.
Yeah.
Matt's the dentist.
Wait, what?
I can punch you at any time.
Tell me when to
stop.
Oh.
Hammer time. Doo-doo. Doo-doo.
The commissar's in town.
I thought it was collaborate and listen. What the hell?
Oh. What do you got, Eric?
Blackberry moonshine.
Nothing good.
That actually sounds delicious.
That doesn't sound inherently bad.
I've listened good, to
I mean,
show.
Except for the moonshine.
Do you don't like blackberries? I like blackberries.
That makes one of us all.
I am aware.
No, blueberries are disgusting.
No, blueberries are great.
No, blackberries are the natural evolution of blueberries into something good.
We're fighting. It's not accent day anymore.
I don't think I want to sit by you.
I don't want to sit by you either.
But how can you not sit together? It's accent day!
Curse you, accent day. Bring
Boy, this
enemies
got off the
together.
Rails so quick.
Oh, honey,
what a surprise.
There were rails?
I remember sending a text message to both Eric and Matt about the Accent Day episode of Honeytown.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because there was a joke waiting to be made for nigh on an entire fucking season. At one point, the lawyer, Jack Hughes.
Wait.
The lawyer.
Do you mean
Jack Hughes!
I think you were the only one that called that out. I mean, I'm sure other people got that joke.
And I threw what I was holding. I threw a toddler tantrum.
No, I know, and that little kid was super pissed because that was the last version of that Barbie.
Right. It was a good Barbie.
Right? Yeah.
It was the American Gladiators one.
Oh.
Whoa.
No, what? I'm joking. It was Hulk hands.
I've got some.
Hulk hands Barbie?
Oh my God!
Yes, I need this in my life.
Me too.
Now.
I very much need that in my life.
Wait, is this a Barbie wearing her size Hulk hands, or is this a regular Barbie?
No, it's a my size Barbie wearing her size Hulk hands.
Yes.
They're petite. Yeah.
The miniature Hulk.
Yeah, and they're, you know.
I am delighted.
And small.
So you know how when you like cook something with wine, you let it reduce down
until it's just like sugar and bullshit.
This smells like someone did that with cough syrup.
Oh,
you're welcome, Eric.
I'm gonna hold you to that donation.
I mean, cough syrup's probably cheaper.
Oh, I will pay it. I got my tax return. I'm making you drink all night.
You don't know what that is. Huh.
Yeah, she was ready to spend it on a harp, but we're aware of that.
But that look right there. Totally worth it.
I've got rum chata.
Wait, I'm sorry. You were buying a harp?
Yeah.
Did we just gloss over something?
What about a harp?
Did someone say they're buying a harp? Did we gloss over something?
You guys, I am going to actually have to disappear for a moment. Actual work calls.
Extreme business.
Okay, as the event coordinator, I need to go fix a thing.
Her time is paused. She'll...
Pause.
Yeah.
You're not getting out of this.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hang on. Oh, what? Mom? Grandma died again?
But you think
you
were going to get out of it?
Pause means you have to still do it.
Yeah. What are you, new? What the hell?
Hand me his booze.
Shut up.
Damn it.
There we go.
My one weakness. Things I like.
So, the drink that Ian brought us is called Ninja versus Unicorn.
Oh, no.
Double India Pale Ale.
Look at this can!
That art
oh my God.
Is insane.
Are you fucking kidding?
That is about as baller as it gets.
This is the most brutal unicorn versus ninja fight I have ever seen.
I am never buying another beer ever.
Someone who's savvier at interwebs, take a picture of this and post it so people can see it.
Oh, I got this.
I already did my social media duty.
Oh,
I
man.
Posted a picture of the blackness.
Hello.
Right. Speaking of dope cans of things, did you guys realize that there's a branded Deadpool can of Mike's Hard Lemonade?
What?
No.
I was going to say gross, but then oddly appropriate.
Right? Yeah, that was the thing. It's like walking through the liquor store, I was like, doop, doop, doop. Oh, cool, Deadpool. Weird. That's strange. It's like a big tall boy. And it's like, Mike's Hard Lemonade. So which made me think two things. One, Mike's Hard Lemonade still exists.
Right.
And two, fuck you, Deadpool. So, of course, one was purchased.
Yeah.
Still in the fridge.
Oh, no, my only weakness. Stuff I like.
Speaking of stuff I like.
Wait, hold on. Didn't you buy two bottles of that Hellboy?
That's where I was going.
Yeah.
that Hellboy Hellwater fire whiskey.
Yeah.
Oh, man, that was the worst goddamn thing.
We once sat in a circle passing that around to anyone unwary enough to drink it.
Yep. It's turns like out, takes a lot of unwary people.
Oh, yeah.
And leaves me with one very full bottle.
Oh, yeah.
So, I now have the one empty bottle that I've preserved and the other full bottle that I'm now considering preserved.
Yeah, it's like action figures. You open one.
That's the you keep one.
Mint condition. Yeah.
So I have mint condition shit whiskey.
Realistically, you just ran out of friends to inflict that on.
Oh, I ran out of friends a long time ago.
I actually think that whiskey is a good way to run out of fucking friends.
That honestly reminds me a lot of one of the things that we do in the campground at the Renaissance Festival is at one of the campfires, somebody years ago had brought a bottle of Dr. McGilliguddy's peppermint schnapps. And it has now become a thing where somebody will be feeling... What's the word I'm looking for?
Thirsty.
Like an asshole.
Oh.
And there's a rule in that campground is if somebody opens the Dr. McGillicuddy's bottle, they can't close it again until it's been passed around to everybody, and and everybody has to take a drink. Unless there's a reason, like an actual reason, they can't take a drink.
Can
so,
having better taste be a good reason?
Nope.
Oh, no,
unfortunately,
that's flimsy.
That is not.
You wouldn't be around that campfire.
Would you be working at a Renaissance festival?
No,
you had
you're right.
Better taste.
Like medical reasons or something like that. But others, so somebody will be, you know, somebody will get salty and just be like, all right.
Yeah.
I'm opening the bottle. It's like, oh.
So did we?
Why'd you have to say that, Larry?
Did we just gloss over that the octopus at the table is too classy to be at the campfire?
I'm a fucking classy octopus. Get it right.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
I'm still wondering about this harp. Who's buying a harp?
Jenna.
Jenna, but she's gone.
No, she got a harp for free.
What?
Then why did she have to pay for it?
She didn't, which means she's got all of that tax return money.
What?
For punishing us.
Wait, what?
I'm really confused.
Oh, wait, so maybe she left to plan.
This is a terrible idea.
Why did we let that happen? Did anyone check that she actually had an emergency, or is she just like fucking Bruce Wayne right now?
Does anybody?
I don't mean like fucking Bruce Wayne, but like is she just Bruce Wayne and had to make an excuse, and pretty soon like
I mean
through the ceiling and it's like ha crap.
Fucking Bruce Wayne is an excuse.
I'd fuck Bruce Wayne.
Yeah.
Everybody would fuck.
Well, it's
Bruce
like
Wayne.
It's like fucking the Queen. You would do it just for the story, and also because Bruce Wayne.
Because every time you look at
because Bruce Wayne
every time
would do
you
it,
look at a British stamp,
Wayne.
You could go. I've had her.
It does matter. Yeah. All these pictures of my ex.
Is it like one of these big floor harps, or is it?
Yeah.
Let's speculate more.
She told us. The thing is, you were present when she told us all about this, and it is recorded.
Me
for
personally?
Posterity. No. Salsa.
Oh. Oh.
Yeah. It was on a podcast.
I can't
Matt,
tell.
I was present because you fucking aren't.
I can't help but lock eyes every time you talk to me. I just assume that you're dreamily like speaking to me, but it turns out not always. So.
No, sometimes I'm dreamily speaking past Salsa to you.
Oh.
It's okay. Here's the thing. I'm not always really good at listening to Jenna.
We know.
Not because she's a woman, but because I don't care.
So normally we talk about things we've been up to or random stuff we want to talk about, but usually at Die Laughing there's one thing that we decide we're going to do because, well, we start talking in circles and never get through anything.
What have you been doing recently?
No.
Die Laughing.
Have you done your introduction yet?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we did.
Man, you really did.
We got through something at
night. We're here for that.
You're fucking up accent day.
Oh, yeah.
What a dick.
It's accident day.
Matt, Eric, I don't listen to you. It's not because you're a guy. It's because I don't care.
Because mentally, it's Salsa's absent day.
Oh, yes, I remember accent day.
I would just like to say that as I think the newest person of this whole endeavor.
Holy shit, you're here.
I am both simultaneously like so confused and so at home at the same time.
Oh, it's okay, dear. Accent day will get you eventually.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, so for sure.
You're like the only person at this table I like. Good job, Kayla.
You're all right. Punchable.
Still true.
Still not untrue, yeah.
She's got like four arms on that side she can
hit. Oh, yeah, that is a problem.
Wait, do you really?
Yeah, it's an octopus. What do you think?
You say that. Oh, well, apparently your octopus has
I,
six.
I need to...
No, my legs, dummy.
Oh, right.
Right, okay. I need to make an announcement for everybody.
An announcement for everybody.
Here's the deal. The PayPal link specific to the drinks is not working.
Okay. Mm.
Oh, no.
So what you will do to purchase a drink for any and or all of us is to go to the main page with the general donation button, enter the comment there that that's what this is for.
Yeah.
So if you want to buy Eric a shot, I'm picking on you, Eric. If you want to buy Eric a shot,
that's fair.
You go to the main page, you click the donate button, you put in the appropriate amount. What is the amount for all of those again?
$20 for a shot, $100 for a round for everyone.
Yeah.
So you will say you will enter $20 on that donate and you will say who it's for, and we'll take care of it that way for now. I can't fix it at this point because I don't have the appropriate access to the PayPal.
The people with access are sleeping.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Would you
is access day?
Is access day?
Can you please pass this beer to Matt?
Oh no! Is it now empty? That would be perfect.
Is abscess day.
I left
is abscess day.
I left you one swallow in there.
You did. I mean, there's just enough lukewarm horse piss backwash in here for me to not be thrilled.
You're welcome.
That's my new band name.
Yeah.
Hey, I give back.
Lukewarm horse
care.
Piss?
Yes.
Girl, you're going places.
So one of the segments we normally do is called Fine Print, where we post kind of
wrenching this thing back
situations.
On the rails.
Yeah. That's kind of my job here. I get to not care when I'm on AON.
It's super dope when you're on neither of these podcasts and don't give a fuck.
Yeah. Like Eric trying to helm this thing is like watching bumper bowling, where just everything veers off to one side and it goes boop.
Also, I swear an hour ago I had a voice. What happened?
But then a child has to, like, they want to run down the lane and follow the ball. Yeah.
So what I posit is you get $1 million.
All right.
Okay.
But for the next,
story checks out.
For the next 2 years, you have to wear a shock collar, and every time you get angry, you get shocked.
Oh no!
Yeah, done.
I'm super into that.
I feel like you and I want that for different reasons.
Wait, like the two of you both want it for like the same different reason?
I mean, the two of us want it because it will work in simpatico.
I'm fine with it because I think I'll get shocked infrequently. He wants it because I think he knows he will get shocked frequently.
Do you think of me as a guy that gets angry a lot?
No, I think of you as a guy that gets like flustered. Like,
is being like confused and like flapping about like Kathy going, gah, is that the same as angry? I just made a Kathy joke. Who am I?
Is Kathy Day?
It's Kathy Day. I'm better than Catheter Day.
I'm going to say no. I'm going to say no right now.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you why.
Oh.
I'm married.
Yep.
And my wife would find reasons to get like,
"Oh, you'd be goaded into
oh
it.
Really? Yeah, exactly."
Oh.
Like,
wow.
Oh, you don't want to do this thing, okay?
Poke.
Oh, God. All right. So, you guys, we have a donation.
Okay.
Round of drinks.
Oh.
From Ted.
Oh.
Love you all plus Kyle.
Ted.
Cheers.
Ted. Wait, okay. Ted loves all of us and Kyle?
Yeah. I think so, yeah.
Or he loves us as much as you could, plus enough for Kyle.
Or is
Does Kyle get a shot?
Leftover love.
Is that what you're saying?
I love you as much as all of you and as much as I love Kyle.
I feel like Kyle gets the overspray.
Here's the thing. First, I think Kyle's a pretty big guy, so
that's a lot of extra love for us.
That's a lot of extra love.
Yeah. Take it.
Second, I think if Kyle is listening and is willing to join us for a shot, I'm willing to include
we'll
him.
Is Kyle around?
But I don't think he has to.
Kyle is probably, if he's wise, Kyle's sleeping.
Yeah.
Sure. Ask him if he's thirsty.
He's going to do his whole I'm Kyle thing.
Oh, my God.
What? He'll come back in with a shitty accent and be like, "It's Kyle Day."
It's Kyle Day. Pun.
My God.
We want to clarify, it's not good booze. So if you got excited,
fair warning. What are we getting moonshine or are we getting something else?
Another fun thing. I'm getting all of the fun news. So the three wireless mics on the end here aren't picking up on the podcast.
Oh.
So I think we're going to share some of these guys.
Clean cup, move down.
Clean cup, move down.
Clean cup.
Let's just get rid of these. Yep, look at it. Just
congeal. Coagulate?
It's not quite.
It's all right. The mics always pick me up anyway.
Oh, I didn't know what it was.
Hello.
I just wanted to say coagulate.
I'm sharing a mic with Jason now.
Well, it's not the only thing
that
coagulates.
I'm going to hog this thing like a motherfucker. I'm just letting you know.
Yeah, the other mic, these three mics were being picked up by the rest of them on the table.
Slide that down near the chair.
This will work.
Yeah.
Okay.
Clean cup. Move down.
Hey, we have a Kyle.
We do.
Hi, Kyle. Hey, Kyle.
Hello.
Kyle, how are you? Did somebody tell you what's going on?
Something about Ted.
Yeah, we can share on that.
Okay.
Is it Kyle?
Okay, so here's what the message.
Yes.
I was wondering why Ted was my first Ren Fest partner who I replaced with
Kate. Right. Oh. Lean in on a mic.
Yeah.
Lean in on a mic.
An upgrade, if you will.
You can be replaced. So,
upgrade, if you will, Ted.
Oh.
So, Kyle, wait, let me explain this first. So Kyle, we got a message that said, round of drinks from Ted, love you all, plus Kyle, cheers. We don't know if he
also loves you.
Oh, yeah.
Or if he wants you to have a shot, but we're willing to give you one.
Yeah.
But this is up to you.
I'll take a shot for Ted.
Aww.
I give him crap, but I still kind of love him.
Aww.
You tell that bitch you got
it, man. This smells like straight up vanilla extract.
Oh, what did you pour?
What does your smell like?
Did you pour out of the same bottle I did?
Yeah.
Oh, it ain't vanilla, son.
No, I know it's not, but I'm saying that's what it smells like.
So much hosting left.
What is this? Yeah,
drinking? Nothing good.
Sweet vanilla.
Kyle, I think you do know what this is. This was a donation to our drink challenge from our very own Kyle Decker.
Oh, no.
I brought nothing good.
I believe your own petard is calling.
Have you been hoisted?
Hoist.
Yes.
Hoisting.
This is a bacon vodka.
No!
All right.
No! I've been drinking Pinot Grigio.
Asses and elbows.
Lauren rejects this reality.
Wait, I'm all of a sudden kosher.
Thank you for the donation, Ted.
Thank you. Because it contains formaldehyde.
Yeah, probably. You'll live forever. Let's do
this. Is this happening? Oh, God.
Okay, what alien symbiote made this and thought, that tastes like bacon, yeah.
Oh. That tastes it's like the asshole of bacon bits. Yeah, it's like the Bacos bacon bits, but like.
Yeah.
Oh God.
I mean, to mention you can in the drink challenge, add that to any of the fearless members in the drink challenge shots for a price. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's.
I would just like to say that I just actively poured my water down my crotch and then just did a shot of bacon flavored whatever, and I'm just having a good time.
So we shouldn't mistake this for you loving the bacon flavored vodka.
No, I get it.
You see what I did there?
I don't think she would ever feel like that close to you.
It's true.
No, that gross.
Only I feel that way about you.
Nasty. Gross, too gross.
Day 37. We were looking to get back on the rails, but we had not found them yet.
One moon circling another.
So back to the shop caller thing.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
So, what level of anger does it go off?
Yeah.
Right.
Did I just unknowingly unbutton my onesie?
Gross. Gross.
Story checks out.
Yeah, I don't want to share microphones anymore.
You know what? I'm gonna ask, how do you clarify levels of anger?
Like, is just like annoyance a level of anger? Like a thing that it would go off for? Or
if
like general frustration?
General frustrations?
Okay. Yeah.
So any level of...
So anything beyond neutral?
Or is it just like a total rage, and that's when it goes up?
Like if you're like a little bit upset about something, you're a little bit annoyed. Not a big deal, but when you start feeling like anger, like you're mad at someone for something, when you are more mad at if a situation happens, you're like, oh, that's unfortunate, and you're like a little bummed. It's not gonna shock, but if you're like, fucking salsa.
I think I'm going to get in a lot of traffic accidents.
If you're fucking
accidents.
Salsa,
that would then you're just angry all the time.
I was going to say,
and that shot collar will be a welcome relief.
You're pretty mad.
I have another question.
Yep.
Does it go off the entire time that you're angry, or does it, just the first time?
Oh, like at the moment of anger, and then you can remain angry. So you're
like
the Hulk,
for
basically.
As long as you need to.
Just the transformation hurts. But after that, you're okay, and you can
I think I could be perma angry.
I feel like you could. Yes, you and I have worked together.
Hey,
I think it's.
It was retail.
Oh yeah, you saw
Lauren's
some shit.
Lauren's collar is going off
you
right now.
You see some dark sides of me.
I think it's just intermittently.
Okay.
Like if you're angry and like so you know like when your alarm goes off and you're like snooze button.
That's not
5
anger.
Minutes later, goes off again.
Oh, I see.
Oh.
So like you get shocked, you're still mad. Couple minutes go by. Still mad, get shocked again.
I think I take the deal. I honestly don't think I'm truly angry that often.
Okay.
I think things are dumb, but I think usually I go, ugh, that's stupid.
Driving?
And that's not angry. That's just more like disappointed in the way the world works.
No, Matt doesn't get angry driving either.
Oh, God, like, no. I don't give a fuck about driving.
He's just
yeah.
like, fucking whatever.
I leave
like,
way early so I have time to get there, and if people are dumb, I'm like, ha-ha, look at that moron.
Point of order. To the original questioner. You say we have to wear a shock collar. In the spirit of the question, do we also... Are we not able to doctor it in any way, shape, or form?
That is correct.
I would have to assume, right?
So, like, I couldn't just take a piece of plastic and put it between the shock collar and my neck and
no.
wear that all the time?
No.
No.
Can I also...
So, consider it an implant for all
okay.
yeah.
intents and purposes,
also,
right?
Also, before so we gloss over that, I just want to say that I think General Frustration is my Sergeant Pepper's only part of called band cover band.
See, the problem with this whole thing, I would have to turn it down. I guarantee you that, because I run a 50-hour comedy marathon.
Also, I've listened to your podcast.
To
you're on there with a bunch of assholes.
Today.
Right?
And it's three.
Yeah. Yeah.
More so than
more so
you do
than, yeah.
already.
I was originally going to say, like, as women in society, we're like, you know, I can't find the right word right now, but like we're trained to not get angry. We get sad or we get like other things, but we're not supposed to have those emotions. But I don't really do that, so like I don't buy into that shit. Yeah.
So I have a question for the table.
You heard it here first. Jenna is endorsing either rage or having a penis.
Or having a rage. Porque
no los dos.
Yeah.
I'll take
I have
rage,
a rage boner
you.
Right now.
Okay. I miss you
so
guys.
Question for the table. Who at the table has been shocked by a dog collar before?
I guess raising my hand doesn't mean much, but yes.
No. Yeah. I'm raising my hand.
Yeah.
Was it last night laughing?
Oh, that's not the only time.
I was
that's
about
fair.
To say
that. I've seen that video. That might have
inspired
something else.
That, well. that's not. That's also not the only other time.
For $19.95 per minute.
I know we
I was
played rock, paper, scissors, and season got shocked.
I mean,
so.
It's on Facebook. You want to see me get shocked with a shock collar?
No, I'm making a sex video joke.
I know you are. I'm just saying.
It's
you know
on
it's,
Facebook?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
No,
your sex video.
What? Well.
Yeah.
Yes, it's
there
very
are
brief.
Pictures of my
Which
dick
one?
On Facebook because they've not been flagged.
That's actually true.
Yes.
Because they don't recognize.
Well, I've been real lucky, and I haven't seen that.
Do we all just gloss over Kayla having the savagest burn of all time?
No. And the best part was, she just dropped that bomb and flew away. Where Lauren would have had the courtesy
She's the
to
silent
write it
but
down
deadly
like
of
Slim
jokes. Just,
are you calling me a fart?
Yeah.
Great, thank you, man.
Well, in the good way.
Yeah, you know, the good
you
kind are, of fart.
You're a sweet release from a buildup of pressure.
I'll take it. That can also be said about, like, nice things, too, right?
Yeah.
I'm talking about orgasms.
Dude. People love ninjas. They pop in and out. No one knows they're there. Farts are good. Orgasms.
Apparently, according to our drink, unicorns know they're there.
Wait, what? Oh, ninjas. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Oh, have we drank that? What is
it? I did. You don't.
Oh.
You can have this one.
Oh, okay.
It's kind of warm.
Some, do you want to share?
I
want to
at least try it and
no.
see what it is.
So I want to say, like, I've been keeping track of time. My 20 minutes is done.
Oh,
so
I know.
Even taking into account my delays. So the rest of y'all that haven't been paying attention...
When do we start?
Look, I'm stuck here anyway. It's not my job to keep track of you.
Yeah.
I'm not on these shows, so you guys have to tell me when it's time to go because I'm not paying attention. It's not my job.
No.
We've got a clock right here. If these assholes can't pay attention.
I'm going to go eat a sandwich until I'm paid to be back on.
Right.
That's fair.
Are there sandwiches?
Yeah. Where have you been?
Sleeping.
Not for you. All right. I'm bugging out until somebody wants me back enough to pay for us.
Are there really sandwiches?
Yeah.
Yes.
In the fridge,
really
there's like sandwich meat.
There
and
have been. They've been there.
Yeah. This whole time?
Yeah.
This whole time.
Motherfucker.
Okay.
See, this is why Jenna wants a shot call.
How long did I have to stay here?
I don't remember. How long was I supposed to be?
Like 15 minutes ago.
Oh.
Cool. I'm going to go get a sandwich.
Bye.
That's fair.
I'll be back.
Did someone buy a theremin?
No, Matt, this is just one of your crazy conspiracy theories.
So, I don't know. Have I told the story of last year with the shock collar having to test everything before die laughing? I don't know that I've told this. So as the person who organizes the challenges, whenever we set something forward for our members to do, we have to test it to make sure that it is safe. So when we decided we were going to do a shock collar challenge, that meant that I had to order and test the shock collar. Now, the shock collar that I originally ordered, when it got there, it said it had four different, it was like 10 different levels of shock, of like intensity. And I'm like, okay, so I'm going to put it on the lowest level, and we're going to try this. So I'm standing in my bedroom with my dog watching me confused. And the instructions say that when the dog barks, it is going to beep to be a first indicator to warn the dog that it's going to shock if the dog barks again. And then the second time it registers, it's supposed to shock you. Now, I put this thing on and I tried to like make a loud noise for it to go off. And it didn't go off. So I'm standing there wearing a shock collar and like barking in my room and nothing is happening. And my dog thinks this is the best thing ever because he's like, oh, we're barking now. So I'm like, okay, let's get up the nerves for this. And I'm like, nothing. Okay. He's just still nervous and I'm like barking. Nothing's happening. And I'm like getting mad at this shock collar. I'm like, what the fuck? Come on, do something. Nothing. And I start going through it and I realize that when they said it had 10 levels of intensity, what they actually meant is it had 10 levels of sensitivity. And I had put it on the lowest sensitivity rather than the lowest intensity. So I basically spent 20 minutes yelling in my room wearing a dog collar for this fucking marathon. So at this point, I was angry and upset. So I turned it to 10. And I barked, and it beeped, and I went, okay, fine, let's do this. And I barked again, and it shocked me, and it was nothing. And I was now upset that I had wasted like half an hour for this thing that did absolutely nothing. So now I'm yelling in my room wearing this shock collar and it keeps giving these little like bzzz, and it feels like someone's just kind of poking you a little bit. And every time it happened, I got angrier and yelled more at the collar. And my dog loved this. And he's just barking and barking and the collar's starting to pick it up. And I'm just like, see, it's nothing. It's just yelling at this stupid little collar before I gave it up and then got one that had a remote.
I'm leaving.
And I went, oh, okay.
Bye, Lauren.
Unless somebody pays to keep me on here, I have to go.
How much do you have to pay again?
$10 hairs.
Just curious, not because I have it open on my phone.
$10 for 20 minutes.
We only have, actually, about...
10, 15.
Somewhere in there. You know what? I'll just throw it in. You hang out.
Okay, yeah, thanks. Listen, I'm awake already. Please buy me onto AON as well.
Plus, that means you get to keep your booze because we keep stealing it back from Matt every time he leaves.
I'm not Matt.
Yeah, but, I mean, kind of on principle and the legacy you left, I have to steal it.
Bitch, it's in my hand.
That's not how this works.
Yes, it is. I'll fight you.
Want to fight about it?
Lamb versus octopus. Let's go.
Ram, thank you very much.
Ram.
Ram. Somebody else have a fine print they want to talk about?
I can go.
Go for it.
So, you get $1 million.
Okay.
For the next year and a half.
That's a weird number. I'm good with it. I'm just pointing it out.
Every 2 weeks, a random body part becomes sentient and is able to talk.
Oh.
All right, so I have to know, how broad or specific is this? Is this like one of the knuckles on a finger? Is this like the finger?
I am so glad I don't have a dick.
Dude, you would think a pussy anyway. Talking is better?
Yes.
Maybe not
I just pictured like
like a little puppet.
Like just like your clitoris with just like the smallest, tiniest little voice.
Girl, my pussy's loud.
You're seeing it in the shower, but you don't know where it's coming from.
I love the internet and just.
Oh. Kayla's my new favorite person, by the way.
So I'm down.
Okay, I do have a question though. Like, can other people hear it?
So
oh my god,
are you
this makes catcalling so much better.
Because the cat calls back.
Wait, so let me get this straight. In your mind, you're walking down the street and some dude cat calls you and your hand just reaches out and it's like, shut up, you son of a bitch.
Oh no, it's not the hand.
Other people can hear it. They think it's you.
Oh, they think it's us. Okay.
Man, I wish I was wearing my pussy is poetry hat right now.
That would be perfect.
Oh man. Oh my god.
Oh my God, do not remember the Quiznos commercials, Kyle. So when you say it has sentience, it moves on its own, it talks on its own, all that kind of stuff. Or is it just it has the exact same functions, you just don't have control over what it does.
The exact same.
So like, is it now like a creature that can talk, or is it just my arm randomly moves? Because those are very different things.
It's a creature that can talk.
So that it's can talk.
And has kind of its own mind of things, but you are still in control of it. But your
so
motions will not override the ability to speak.
So it's basically like if someone glued a small animal to me.
Pretty much.
This sounds great.
It at least sounds interesting. I'm in.
I already wanted a cat, like a.
Start baby talking to yourself.
I've already been accused of using like stand up as Tinder, so why not podcast? Ladies.
Oh my god.
You good, Lauren?
I don't think I've stopped laughing since you said my pussy is loud.
Oh my god.
Oh my gosh. I don't want that. Just, you know.
Yeah, my tits are already mad that they're not like the same size. I don't need them arguing about it.
They start talking to each other. They're like individual personalities.
No, but since it's only one body part, it's like all of a sudden one of your tits is just like yelling at the other one. And like two
the other
weeks
one's
later,
just like real sad.
You're just getting like one-sided.
Or like, do they both talk at the same time? Like, so like you hear it as like a Greek chorus.
They're amazing at harmonies. They actually start getting record deals.
Oh my god! Oh. I love this concept now.
Oh, man. Think about it, man. An album.
Titty album.
Call them your tits.
Call them your tits.
My tits are not Enya, okay? No, I think my pussy is loud is the next t-shirt.
Oh, my God, I want that.
I'd wear that on a t-shirt any day.
Yeah.
Dude, I will cross-stitch you that.
Yes. Oh, my God. There is nothing I would love more.
Oh, man.
I feel like the album is Calm by Your Tits. So Calm, colon, Your Tits.
But it's like a girl punk band.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah.
This is amazing. Like a proper like riot girl.
Yeah.
Just above Pussy Riot.
Yeah. Ooh. I hope your tits don't go to jail though.
Yeah. Me too.
No, outside. Yeah. Outside pieces.
The question was about internal organs.
Liver starts complaining? No.
I feel like if it's ever your internal organs, you're just going to hear like...
My internal organs already complain.
Yeah,
dude. Sounds like a kidnapping for the next 2 weeks.
It's like, what was that? My stomach is growling.
I'm really hungry right now.
Oh, man.
You know what? I got to say, just on principle, I'm in. Just because I'm curious.
Yeah.
I just have to know.
I'm in.
It's
going
to be a mistake, and I'm going to regret it.
You just
want to
see how far the rabbit hole goes, that type of thing.
Whoa.
Ladies. I suppose for that 2 week period, sure.
Periods aren't 2 weeks.
Oh.
What's that?
Matt, get back here. And then a note.
Oh, that's from me. Yeah.
And then Lauren, it looks like you have some extra time on AON.
Oh.
Nice.
That's coming.
I hope he's not.
I'm just breathing hard. Shut up.
Lol.
Hi, Matt.
Hi.
Did you enjoy your sandwich?
I fucking did. Oh, I also just farted, so good luck.
I mean, we're out of here in two minutes.
Wait. I listened to when you were talking yesterday.
Yeah, I'm hotboxing this narwhal.
You said whenever you fart in that narwhal, it's stuck in there.
Yeah, I'm like a crockpot of fart.
So as long as no one like pokes you, then
I don't know.
Good. But if someone does, then you're like one of those puff spore mushrooms.
No, it's those Glade plugins type thing. Just gradually release like the scent.
Oh, gradually, or is it like the? Oh. Fuck you, Jenna.
All right, what are we doing?
Kayla, do you have a fine print?
Oh, yeah. Hold up. I got one here in my little phone. So I thought of this while I was, like, sleeping downstairs, so we'll see.
You
dreamt it?
What
are we saying? Okay.
You can think of things while you're sleeping?
It was one of those, like, things where you're fading in and out of sleep, mm-hmm. you know?
That would save me a lot of time. Okay.
Yeah. Came to her in a dream.
Yeah. So you get $1 million.
That used to be a prophecy. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh,
let's just stop there. I'm good with it.
Sold.
You get $1 million, but for 1 year, your life is more dramatic in the sense of it's either like an anime or like a soap opera for a year.
Oh.
Complete with just every time someone's talking to you, there's like a proper like you know, like all
so
the
like,
anime noises, like, and
so
all that stuff.
So
that
I could, like, so die and come back to life if it's a soap opera?
Yeah!
Or are we saying, like, is the anime or soap opera an actual choice? Like, do I get to decide, like, oh, man, every day might be like, ah, oh, shit, here comes that robot. Or is it, ah, oh, shit, here comes my evil twin that I never knew.
I think it, you know, it's like swaps between.
Oh, you don't. So every day is a roll of the dice. Like, will it be my goateed evil twin? Oh no.
So for a year,
just another jungle fever.
And every conversation you have is like, you know, very dramatic. You know, like there's a lot of gasping. There's a lot of like, oh, you know, all that stuff.
So everything sounds like it's mid coitus.
So I'm.
Yeah.
So I'm the evil twin.
But not that evil.
Oh.
Aww.
Damn.
Point of clarification.
So you know in anime when it takes like four episodes for Goku to like build up his power and go, like, would that be every orgasm?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh
my I'm in.
I feel like I'm pretty much. Yeah. That's kind of that seals the deal, so to speak.
Foreplay for days.
Frost I'm the in. Deal. I don't know.
doesn't that mean it takes you like 4 days to achieve an orgasm?
Are you not super into that idea?
No.
Well, guess I know who I'm not fucking.
It takes 4 days to get there, but once you do, it destroys a fucking town.
Eric, the trick is the journey.
Nope.
Then get in the audience, damn it.
I see a Kyle
that was a freebie.
Coming on stage.
It's funny you all say that. It's now time, according to the schedule, for the AON podcast.
Oh.
All written.
You're on my time now.
That's
so,
fair.
So I think it's time to do a change.
Do they need to, like,
close
up?
Don't go change.
I don't need to move.
I probably do.
Yeah, I don't either. Right now, Eric, do I have 40 minutes here?
There was never even a button for me.
I have 60 minutes here? Dang. Great. Just right, 60 well, more to go to make this worth my time.
Yeah, we're 2 hours.
Yeah, I know. I'm already on for 60 hours, so I need the last 60
minutes.
Whoa. Listen, I've been up for a while.
All right,
do I get to keep my
beard? I'm keeping my
hair. Her hair's funny.
Fuck off.
It is. It was like boop, boop, boop.
I'll sit over here.
Okay.
All right. Everyone.
Are you not getting your booze?
Yeah, we're fine.
Hello, my love.
We get music.
Yeah, this is our intro music. Dope.
Sweet.
Here it comes, Salsa. You ready?
Yes, I am, as a matter of fact.
Thank you. If you think that's going to stop me.
Ladies and gentlemen, buckle up for the sex.
It's the Apropos of Nothing podcast.
With your host,
Salsa.
James.
And Jenna and...
Why are you looking at me? Oh, hi, I'm Matt.
And we are joined by very special guests,
Eric.
And Lauren! Yay!
Wait, am I not a special guest? Have I not heard that?
No. No. Bitch, you ain't special about nothing. You just came out of retirement for a few minutes.
No, here's the thing. You overplayed your hand. When they looked at you and you said your name, you lost.
Yep.
Yeah.
Son of a bitch.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, as you will have heard by the theme music, we are now the Apropos of Nothing podcast. It is not really different from what you just saw, but I mean, technicalities.
But better in some indescribable way.
For his accent day!
His accent day! Oh my God!
His accent day! I'm not in charge anymore!
Have some more booze, Eric. AON has accent day. Well,
nice. That's a sweet accent you're thinking.
Yep. What this means is there's a very important change that has happened, and that is we have different drinks for the drink challenge.
Hello, hello.
Did we go get those, or are they just...
No, they are hovering just backstage.
Oh.
Ew.
Wait, right. You actually hovering?
Yes, levitation.
I don't know.
I'm disappointed. I see nothing hovering.
I think it's gross in this particular instance.
Did you get anything backstage?
I should point out that someone should get those, actually. Because...
they will be repeated.
Josh is on it.
Well, Matt has
we have booze
Matt
backstage
has
that we need?
He has to take care of from one Troy to Troy.
Yay!
Oh.
That's Troy.
Oh, hold on.
No, that's
oh.
not ours.
Yeah, he wants it.
Oh.
Just no, swig off
we
of
have,
it.
No, we have special booze for this, Josh.
Oh, God.
Here, we have very down. Special booze.
Oh, no.
So very special. And we slow. Made it ourselves, you guys.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
What the shit?
Oh, yeah. Oh, God.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Buckle up for the drinks.
Because of one hero listener's persistence in reminding us, we have Jolly Rancher vodka.
Oh, yes.
Woo!
that we made ourselves. We've got cherry, blue raspberry, grape, watermelon, and green apple. And let me tell you,
Matt, honey, nothing good is about to happen.
Two of these are pretty good. The other three are not.
Give Matt the watermelon.
Yeah, Matt, you get watermelon. No, Matt gets watermelon.
Because it's the best one, right?
Yes.
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 Oh, so like I said, you have two from Troy to Troy.
Oh, well then, give him, what was... The grape was actually
raspberry.
Pretty good.
The cherry.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the cherry.
Cherry.
Yep.
Cherry.
Fuck that, son. Those look like they're urine samples. They from truly someone who's really sick.
Also, somebody get James a drink because there's something special.
Oh,
everything
about this is sticky. No, no. Yeah, everything about that is sticky.
Oh,
yeah.
Just as a reminder, there is still a matching grant that's going on.
Yes.
We have received some donations. But I know we haven't received all 250 for that matching grant.
We need to hit that matching grant.
No, son, no. That was not what I was concerned with. I'm an older, wiser man since when I was on this podcast. I fear this.
I don't know that I believe that.
No. All right, so this being the Apropos of Nothing contest.
Yep, yes.
This being the Apropos of Nothing podcast, we're going to go with what you guys
call it. Is Ass Scent Day.
It is...
See, Matt, he's way funnier than you are.
Yeah.
I regret nothing. Let's be very clear. This thing has gone just fine without me.
I'm just trying to get...
What?
Saint Petre.
Yay!
Saint Petre.
To Matt, drink form. Request to talk faster because I listen to podcasts at 200%.
Eat a dick.
Wait, Matt. Say it slow.
Yeah.
Wow, did he just down the entire
thing? Yeah, yes, he did.
I am so goddamn sticky right now.
Did he need to do it
like that once?
Matt, say that slow.
No, say it a lot faster. So, hey, guys.
That wasn't sexy?
No.
Hey, guys, what you been up to?
I've been doing this right.
I've been up to a 50-hour comedy.
If anybody says anything other than die laughing, then fuck you.
I'm going to literally go wash my hands. That's a good bet. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Please do, and then, you know, come back, because we miss you.
With a question mark audibly placed at the end.
And an Intero bag?
Yeah.
So no, you guys, what have you been doing?
Okay, so far, I have watched a significant amount of comedy, both from backstage and from the audience. And right now, I got to say, I have laughed hardest at two specific acts.
Oh.
Sure.
And they were within fairly quick succession after each other. They weren't immediately succeeding each other, but they were pretty close. And those would be Fraudini and Mary Jo Peel.
Yes.
Neither of these is a surprise.
No.
At all. But holy shit. Like, okay.
Give me details.
Yes, I'm... So Fraudini is a character or act or... What
I would say a caricature.
There we go. Yeah. Of Pisbord the Magician. Where he does a mentalist act. And here's the thing with I was going to say his real name, but Pisbor, is that guy is so goddamn funny.
Name dropper?
That he was able to dump an entire glass of water on my stage, including... fucking close to the electronics.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Very, very.
And I wasn't even angry. That's how funny he was.
Nice.
So I fuck. Like, do we want to really get into
like details? Or
we shouldn't get too much into the minutia because it's a work in progress.
Oh yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
That was literally his beta test.
Let's just say it was a ventriloquism.
It was mental.
It was mental.
It was mental.
How very cerebral.
But really, if you've heard us talking about Pizpuri in the past, the fact of the matter is everything that guy, he's fucking comedy Midas touch.
Yeah.
That guy is funny as shit. And then Mary Jo Peel, it's Mary Jo Peel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, if I need to explain why that's significant, Google it. Jesus Christ.
We had Pat Levon and Mary Jo Peel back to back,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Both
yeah.
of whom have been regulars at Fearless Lab at Honey for about the last year. I get them in about every 3 months or so. So
was that like a humble brag?
No, not at all. What I'm saying is that's what's so cool is that the sets people saw tonight, I've seen pieces of over the last year. And then tonight I saw the honed version. And they've been doing them other places.
Culmination,
but I got to go, oh, I see where this is going. This is actually that bit that they did. Oh,
that's
wow.
cool.
And so watching kind of a final product of stuff they tried out in like 8-minute chunks over the last year. So like everyone here that saw it and loved it, and rightfully so, like I got to see the bits and pieces. And I don't think I've ever had that opportunity before. It was really fascinating to watch.
I was actually talking with Pat Levon downstairs before his act. Because I was working, and he was talking about how much he appreciates Fearless Lab, because he's given actual time to work on his stuff, as opposed to like most other open mics in the area where you're given like 3 to 5 minutes.
Yeah,
and you just you don't get the time to actually test out that material and figure out what's working and what's not. What
yeah
you get like a nice wine.
Yeah,
you know?
I book an hour and I try to book it with 4 or 5 people. Which is way less than like a standard open mic.
Right.
Because I like to give people, they're like, how long do I get? Like 3 minutes, 4 minutes? I'm like 5 to 10, depending on what you got. And they're like, really?
Yeah.
You never get a chance to let something breathe at an open mic. Mm-hmm. And I think we can do that. That's the whole point of it being experimental.
Right.
And some people are like, oh God, I can't feel that. Give me 4 minutes. Okay, you get 4.
How
you know,
cool would it
it's
be?
It's really fun.
How cool would it be to have a documentary where you saw, at the beginning, you saw the finished product? And then the documentary went back and went, here's all of the open mics.
I'd watch
stuff
the
that
shit
they did.
Out of that.
Oh, yeah.
But that's because I'm.
As it evolves, and then you see the snippets of the jokes evolve slowly, you know, and you see all of the bad shit that got cut and the little evolutions and stuff that happened.
Yes.
I would absolutely watch that.
I still don't see how this is not a humble brag.
Because it's Matt. There's nothing humble
because
about it.
Because it has nothing to do with me. Lab exists outside of me being a part of it. When I'm gone, Lab will still exist and hopefully keep doing the same thing, which is just giving people opportunities. I've just been lucky enough to be around during these performances, and that's the way I look at it. So, yeah, not a humble brag. They don't care about me. They just simply contacted a place that has offered them time. And, oh, by the way, if we haven't mentioned it yet, if you would like stage time and you live in Minneapolis, you can shoot me an email or message me on Facebook. I have a very public email, matt.alex@gmail.com, or find me on Facebook and send me a message and say, hey, I'd like to perform. And the next time I have an open slot that works out with your schedule, you get to perform. That's how it works. It's that simple. And I don't screen people. You don't have to send me your stuff ahead of time. You just show up and play. Because people need the opportunity to try comedy, which is a big thing that we're doing in general for Fearless. It's just sometimes you just need a stage in a room to find out if this is for you or not. I had someone that was absolutely stellar at Lab 2 months ago, and I said, you're brand new. I would love to have you be one of my performers at Lab during Die Laughing. And about 3 weeks ago, I got a message that was like, hey, thanks for the opportunity, but I've done 2 or 3 additional open mics since I did yours. It's not for me. I don't think that's what I want to do. I'm really sorry. I hope I'm not putting you in a bind. I said, no, not at all. I can find people to fill it. But that's the point of having the thing is maybe you think I'm going to be a comedian and I'm going to do stand-up. And you go, oof, woof, nope, I'd rather be a director or a producer or work in a factory. I don't care. They're all equally valid career choices.
Different
you know?
Brand of, you know.
Yeah, or whatever it is. But like whatever you want to do, but like you got a chance to find out. That's all it is. So like it's totally fine. And like I think, like I said, Lab isn't mine. Lab is. And I hope if I'm ever not doing it, someone else does. And the reason I'm doing it is because no one else was. Mm-hmm. And that's all it is. Like, there's no me owning that, you know?
There seems to be a pile of challenges.
They are stacking
that we
up.
We should probably get through before they
I think these are for after.
Because these are.
Oh, Eric is. Has the challenge.
You can just hand them to
yeah.
guy.
Oh, okay. We should probably send them down to Eric.
Probably. I didn't want like seven shots to build up or something.
Oh,
like
no,
that.
No.
Okay.
While we're on the topic of fearless letting people have the opportunity to do things, Eric.
Yeah.
Do you want to talk about your stand-up set? Yeah, Eric was on the podcast a week ago.
No, I mean, I'll gladly talk about it.
Okay. Eric was on the podcast.
I'm sorry, is this a humble brag?
You piece
name
of
dropper.
Shit. But no, Eric was on Apropos of Nothing just a couple weeks ago. Was it even last week?
It was last week.
I don't even know. It's fucking.
It's been like
3:45.
4 days.
I guess technically
it's
last
Sunday
week.
Morning. Yeah.
So, Eric's never done stand up, and this.
Well, I've never done something.
That's not
this
true.
A half hour set.
Yeah.
And he did a half hour set today.
I've done some stand up before at a great place called Fearless Lab. Mm-hmm.
I've never heard
name
of it.
Name dropper.
So I mean, and that's a really
humble
cool
brag, and the living is easy.
I mean, let me
so
be
the
a
comedians
shill.
Are popping, and the credit is mine. Okay, go ahead.
Let me continue to shill as I drink this delicious True Stone coffee.
Stone.
Lauren is so pissed at how off key I am.
Yeah. I didn't like it. But also, I expected nothing less.
Shit. While Eric is looking at these new slips we just got, I should point out, if y'all missed it, Aiden set up a thing that was basically a rap battle between Jason and Aaron earlier today, at which Aaron found out to her dismay that Jason is an actual rapper.
Yes.
Because we all know Aaron is an amazing improviser. Lounge Lacey's astounding. And it was vastly entertaining. They both did very well. Jason had the edge, obviously. The show was running short. And so Jason started going, all right, I'll just freestyle for a bit. And he called for suggestions from the audience, and he'd rap for a while. And on like the third one he got, he did a rap that turned into a plug for Die Laughing as a Whole, and then the Lyritics set, which is up next. So it ended up being this like 4, maybe 5 minute long rap that just absolutely broke down what's great about everything we did this weekend and what was going to be so good about their set coming up. It was astounding. And then he just walked off stage, changed outfits, and then came back and did an actual set. It was so fucking great.
Dang.
I cannot
highlight
wait
of the weekend.
I can't wait to edit that video.
It was so good.
And they were right. That song is stuck in my head.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, if you've not seen Lyritics and you get the chance, do it.
We had a fucking dance party going on backstage.
Oh, yeah. It was so great.
And I definitely want to continue this conversation, but I do want to say that I do have True Stone in front of me. So if somebody wants True Stone, I have glasses and we'll share with the people on this
stage. I could definitely use some True Stone.
Oh, my God. Thank you, True Stone, for powering us through this 50 hours.
Oh,
hour.
There are bigger glasses. Yeah. You want to give me like a half of one of those?
I brought bigger glasses,
So it comes in bigger glasses.
Do you want me to pour while you talk about your stand-up set, or not want to talk about your stand-up set?
No, that's
set
great. I'll gladly talk about my stand-up set. So I have done a total of 3 stand-up things before this, all at Lab, with the latest one being not my choice to do at Lab. So after a show in, I guess it was end of November, beginning of December, we were hanging out at a bar after doing a random mystery show thing, and we were all talking, and I was joking about how my wife told me I was doing too many shows and I needed to stop for December, which the conversation went, well, I have some shows that I need to do that I've already committed to, and she's like, okay, you can do the ones you've committed to, but don't do anything extra. So, for clarification, in December, I only performed in 6 shows.
Oh, Jesus.
So that was my late month.
She's holding you back, man.
So
she's keeping you sane.
Did you just Yoko that Ono?
Oh, yeah, because I can't do it to my own wife.
But we were hanging out, and it was like, okay, when are you going to do stand-up again? And this is not my wife. This is someone else asking me when I'm going to do stand-up again. And I'm like, I don't know, maybe like, I don't know, sometime soon, like a Lab or something. And they're like, oh, so like December. And I went, yeah, no.
What?
No, I'm not allowed to do it in December. And I told this story while we were sitting at the bar, and Matt goes, all right, your name's down for January. And I went, you son of a bitch. And he goes, it's in my phone. Sorry, it's already happening. I'm like, God damn it. So then I had to write a stand-up set for January because Matt is the best kind of jerk. Because he will, well, he'll, the thing is with Lab, and I think this is really essential, especially for some of our newer Fearless members who make a comment that that's like, you know, I want to try improv, or I want to try stand-up, or I want to try this. Whenever you say, I want to try this thing, and you don't put like a date on it, it'll never happen.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah. And Matt is very good at going, okay, you want to try that thing. All right. The May Lab. That's when you're doing it. And you're like, what? And he's like, yeah, I have you down for the May Lab. Yeah. You're like, oh, shit. Now I have to figure that out in a month and a half. Okay. All right, let's figure this out. And then you do. Because that's just kind of what Fearless supports.
Can I point out, I learned that actually from AON. Yeah. We had
Name
Joseph.
Dropper.
Right?
Yes.
Years at this point ago, we had Joseph Scrimshaw on, and I talked about the idea of he's a prolific playwright and writes books and comedy. And I was, how do you do it? What keeps you motivated? He goes, book a show. You'll write a show by the time that show's due.
Yeah.
And I was like, really? He goes, yeah. Literally, book a show 2 months out. You will have a play by then, or you will feel completely destroyed and be a jackass and never be able to get booked again. You will create something if you have to have it done. Mm. And that is not what I do. When people go, I think I'd like to try stand-up. How about next week? Mm-hmm. And you know what? Turns out everybody can do stand-up in a week or a month or however long it is if you tell them that's when they're going to do it. That is something I learned from Joseph Scrimshaw because we had him on AON. Yeah. That has absolutely completely changed my comedic philosophy.
I just want to point out that's what passes for commitment around us is it's in my phone.
Wait, hold on.
I had a relationship.
Can I just mention that it's really strange that Matt is the person who has the expertise on commitment?
I've got at least two more than most people on this stage.
To be fair, that show commitment, which results in the other kind of commitment.
No, no, that's commitment.
That's why I wasn't allowed to perform in December.
God, shut up.
But it's absolutely true. I think anybody, like,
Lauren can't punch
a lot
me
of us
here.
Work at the Renaissance. A lot of us work at the Renaissance Festival, and that is something that every single one of us has experienced every year. It's
Lauren.
Every year. It's like
I don't.
It is 3 days before fest, and we're just like, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I don't have my costume put together. I don't know my choreography. Like I don't know the lines to my show. I don't know any of this. And day one happens, and the show is fucking great. And
what are we doing, Matt? Quick, grab a banana peel.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. Like that all shit that just comes together if you have that.
So.
That timestamp on it.
I was talking with Jessa about this, actually.
Jessa, who completely destroyed during vilification tennis earlier tonight, by the way. We should point out, God damn, she's brutal.
That's the word around the bathrooms.
Clearly, Talon skips a generation.
Shit. Yeah, no.
Versus never landing in salsas.
That's not accurate. It skips two. So anyway... but she was asking me, like, what's the best character, like, street character you've ever played at Fest? Because I don't do as much street anymore with my actual, like, fancy paying shows up there. And she goes, she wanted to know what the best street character I had was. And I was like, I think it was Nettie the fishmonger.
I honestly thought you'd say Nettie. Yeah.
Yeah. I think Nettie was possibly my best one. And she's like, well, what did you do for Nettie? I'm like, well, a week before Fest was opening that year, I went, shit, I should probably come up with something because I'm not in a group like last year. And I had all these costume pieces, and I put them together, and I was like, all right, I've always wanted to try a fishmonger character. Like, fuck it. So, like, 3 days before open, I'm buying an oar, like a wooden oar, and, like, a fisherman's hat. Just to, you know, help solidify that. And like a net. Like I found a net.
Well,
somewhere.
I think
which is surprising that you can find all of that at Goodwill.
No, I actually had to go somewhere special for the goddamn oar because I wanted a specific
specialoars.com.
That net, by the way, was a great costume piece.
It was.
Yeah.
But I would point out, I think.
But here's the thing. Like, she was like, that was like 3 days before Fest opened. I'm like, yeah. She's like, so you just knew all the fish jokes? I'm like, no. That happened the night before.
Yep.
When I was sitting around Old Man's Fire, and I was like, I should have something to do tomorrow. And I was like, fish jokes. I'm going to Google some fish jokes. Why not? And that was pretty much it.
Well, as people fish say, like, jokes, art thrives on its limitations, and people always say necessity is the mother of invention. I think what that boils down to is that when you have no time or a timeline that seems too short, what it does is it gives you a limited number of options, which makes you decide, what do I really want to do, and how can I make these things service that? And what you actually end up doing is what you would have done all along had you spent a year planning it.
Right.
Because you go, oh, fuck, you know what would be really cool if I could turn this into a mermaid or a knight or a clown or a, you know, tightrope, whatever. Like, whatever the thing is, you try to force everything into the thing you wished you'd done in the first place. But if you had all your options laid out, you might dick around with too many other things. I think you actually end up cleaving closer to your art.
Yeah, you bypass the analysis.
You
paralysis.
Have to prioritize real fucking quick.
Yeah, out at Fest, Kyle and I, who are also, we're like, MCs
do I have
right
to
now.
Drink this? Was that part of a thing
by the way,
paid for?
You have to do a shot.
Okay. I want to mention Kyle and I have an MC challenge, and which is also my high school rap name. we have an MC challenge going right now that if we raise $400 during our shift, which is a low bar to hit,
especially with a $250 matching grant.
Right, it's the only bar we know.
I know several bars.
that we will lick like full on palm with tongue Nintendo Switch cartridges. They are impregnated with a bittering agent that makes children spit them out. And if you know anything about children, you know that they're not likely to spit cartridges or anything. Like, they will eat
like,
everything they're not supposed to.
Hold on.
Dope rhymes.
Yeah.
Wait. So here is the human child. They are unlikely to spit cartridges.
Yes.
James, what access do you have to kids that you fucking think this?
Like, I have
what
a nephew.
You?
None anymore.
Yeah, no shit.
Is access day.
Is access day.
No.
My understanding is that people have licked these and vomited before.
Yes. Yeah.
Like,
no, I
was straight on like, this is not, they're not as, actually, it sounds like they're fucking around.
As
they're
part of a joke commitment, I did already lick one time, one of these cartridges fucking months ago. One, I still wake up sweating. With the memory of that. It actually seriously ruined my palate for the entire day.
I would say you're ready for sideshow.
Yeah. It was...
There you go.
It was miserable. So there's that. We have purchased from GameStop two brand new cartridges.
They're
two
used.
Brand new to us cartridges.
Oh, I feel
never
like the
before.
Fact. Hold on, I feel like the fact that they're used makes it a little bit worse because you don't know who the fuck was
as
fucking around
this,
with that before.
She's like, "Oh, are you buying this for somebody? You're buying?" I was like, "I'm buying it for a comedy marathon." And she goes, "Well, how do these factor into a comedy marathon?" And I was like, "We're gonna lick them," and she goes, "Oh."
See,
she was like, "Well, do you want the warranty?"
See, James, if you were here for my comedy set, you would have known that you needed to be way more sarcastic when telling the truth. No, these aren't a gift. They're totally for a comedy marathon.
He says, checking out of a Walmart with tarps, duct tape, and a machete. That's so, no, I...
get the baby formula.
Kyle and I had a plan that I was going to dress in armor... And I was going to be this silent character out there and everything like that.
For Fest. Yeah.
And it was this grand plan this that just fucking didn't come together until the middle of the run. And in the meantime, a different character happened. And it's now the character that I was known for. Because I was helping somebody change a tire and they were like, oh, you who? What do you do out here? And I was like, oh, I'm a knight.
Apparently.
I'm a knight character. And they were like, out at the joust? three stars. It's a restaurant. Yes.
That actually does come from the tire company.
I know.
Yes.
So I.
Dad, are you gonna drink that or stare at it?
A little of each.
I've been staring at it for a while.
Let's all
yeah.
stare
drink
at it.
Do it.
Lauren's putting on creepy.
pinkies I'm out.
Do it. Calm down. Take your shot.
Come on, for Troy to Troy.
Come on.
He's fancy accent day.
Yeah, there it goes. How is that for
nope.
you?
No,
he doesn't like it.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Taste it.
This is what I remember cough syrup tasting like when I was a kid.
Yep.
No.
So
that's
anyway.
The cherry.
Yeah, so she was like, well, who are you out here? Are you anybody else? And I was like, oh, I'm Other Squire. And she was like, Other Squire! We love you!
So,
we
so
love Other
Squire.
Squire.
You are Other Squire.
Other Squire, yeah. And the thing is, I just wander around with a sign that says Other Squire, and it doesn't make sense until I'm standing next to Kyle, who has a sign that says Squire. And the best part about it is that we naturally stand in a particular order, and we find... Oh, also Squire. So
you
also
don't even
Squire.
Know your own character's name.
Story does not
right.
Work out.
So,
no, it does.
So
no,
I am drunk and tired. yes,
James, I believe one of those.
So I.
Wait, don't you work overnight?
Yes, but I usually sleep before that.
So have I told the story about? Me getting recognized when Matt and I went wine tasting
the wine
after
festival.
No.
I've gotten a recognition story after you're done.
So I was there for Fest Friday a few years back, and for those that aren't aware, it is set up so that like school field trips happen, and we do a weird day of Fest that is kind of like half school field trips and shopping day, and then like half. Regular day, but most people
but
didn't
mostly
show up, kind
accent
of.
Day.
Mostly accent day.
Above all, is accent day.
So there's a place nearby, a wine shop that has a lot of like specialty liquors and other cool stuff, and they do a wine tasting every Friday. So we're like, if we duck out of Fest, like right when Cannon goes off, we can get there and have free wine. And then go into the last 2 days of Fest after having free wine.
Oh, yeah.
Because why not? And
Jesus.
Wow.
Delivery.
There is a please do
uh-oh.
Now.
So.
Okay. Oh, we have a please do now stack.
Oh.
Oh.
Record scratch sound.
Okay.
Okay.
You think that's what a record scratch sound? No, that's the Scooby-Doo surprise noise. Right.
We will take care of these in a moment. After as a promise to Jay Ashton Green.
Yay!
Oh, God.
But so Matt and I duck out and we go to this little wine shop, and we had changed into civvies, so we are not wearing our costumes. And there are some people there that are in costume, and the two of us are just exhausted. And while we are having our wine and ignoring everyone else around us who is wearing Fest clothes,
swirling
loudly,
just long enough to make it look like we cared before getting another one.
To be like, swirl, 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 chug. Nope. And then like, yeah, you know, I need like the full taste. Fill the glass. And the guy's like, I don't give a fuck. This is my last thing, and just fills it up. And at one point, like Matt and I are talking quietly and just ignoring everyone else, and someone turns and they go, "You're Pietro the poet."
Oh my God.
And I went,
I knew you hadn't.
The full on, yeah.
And
yeah.
I went,
shit.
What? And Matt just looks at me like, what the fuck just happened?
Because you've only worked there a few years. I've been there fucking since 1996.
And
literally fucking,
shit out
literally
you.
Since 96.
Yeah, I remember the 1900s.
Because I was part of the opening gate show, and they started quoting my lines in the opening gate show.
Oh my God.
Yeah, dude. Shit. And it started off as Matt being like, why the fuck are you being recognized? And after like 5 minutes go by, Matt's got this look of like, I'm glad it's not me.
Yeah, I'm
right
ready to go
now.
Start the car because like that's.
Do you need me to like pull up real quick,
right?
Like, screech and open the door for you so you can get in and we can just book it the fuck.
There's
up.
No time.
We're slowly backing away.
Do you need a safe word? Like,
all right, the safe word is harder.
Jenna, you said you had a story, and while we're getting that ready, do we have Keith nearby to get him up here to take care of some of these challenges?
Ooh.
If
yeah.
not, is there a Kyle in earshot?
There is a Kyle.
There
seeing
is a Kyle.
Cool. I'm going to step away from Mike.
We did it, Kyle. Yeah.
Okay. So this story is actually a Bill Young story.
Yay.
He had a gig out in Alexandria.
Ooh.
Right? Like butt-ass middle of nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
And so we go to this gig. Like, I was very supportive, and I would go with him for some of these things. And it was like, Just driving out, like, it's like an hour, hour and a half, some shit like that. Just fuck off all the way there. So middle of nowhere, Minnesota. And he does this gig. And afterwards, we're just kind of hanging out. And, you know, audience will come up and say, hey, good job, or things like that. And so this woman comes up and she's like, hey, good job. And then she walks over to me and she's like, you do vilification tennis.
Oh. Whoa.
And Bill, like, looks over
Thunder
and he goes,
stolen.
Fucking even here? Like, I can't get away from you fuckers. I tell better dick jokes than you guys. What the shit is going on? This is my goddamn... Like, it's just... This. And she's like, do you know him?
That's even better. Oh,
yeah, that's
shit.
My husband.
I've heard, like, a lot about your dick, she says.
She's basically like, oh, yeah, yeah, you were funny.
He's my attaché.
To talk to me about vilification tennis.
This is my driver, Kato.
I have a story, too.
Yeah?
It's a short one, but...
Okay, it's like
so,
you.
Yeah, exactly. So out at Fest, my wife is also a performer out at Fest, but by dint of me doing... vilification tennis and you know, a bunch of street and you know, Casimir and stuff like that. When we're out, you know, if I am often recognized.
Right.
You know. And so, like, there was one day we were out and this person saw my wife and was like, oh, you know, I saw you at Fest, blah, 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 and just proceeded to gush at her and ignore me. And they walked away, and my wife just looks at me and goes, ha!
Yes! Yes! Excellent. I like your wife. She's pretty fantastic.
She's pretty... Oh, can I tell you a quick Salsa's wife story?
Oh.
Whoa.
say it slow.
Tread lightly, my friend.
Oh, trust me.
It's okay. He said quick.
So...
Oh, so it's a story about me.
So earlier today, one of our fellow Fearless members, Nancy, did a set and needed someone to do like a drum roll. And so Salsa was like, yeah, I'll get a drum and we'll do that. And then you had your lovely wife swing by and drop off the drum. And so I was sitting out in the lobby here at the lovely Phoenix Theater, and Salsa's standing outside, and we're like, what the fuck is he doing? Like, he's not having a cigarette. I'm like, no, that's the look of a man waiting for someone to drop something off, or they're just going to pull over and then take off.
Oh, yeah.
And yeah. Megan's like, oh, good point. And so Megan and I are sitting there. This car pulls up. Salsa runs over, opens the back, pulls out a drum. And, like, there's a quick, like, hey from the people inside to Salsa. And as that pulls away, Megan goes, God damn. Salsa's wife and her sister look so similar.
Oh, my God.
And I said, you know they're twins, right?
Oh, my God, yes.
She goes, ugh. Because later on, earlier tonight, her friend Robin and Robin's twin sister came to watch the shows we did.
Yes.
She's like, well, I can totally tell them apart. I'm like, yeah, and I can totally tell the Sterlings apart. Yeah. You just have to be around them long enough. Yeah. But she just, that was the first time I think she'd ever even seen the two of them together in a room. Yeah. She's like, wow, are they like what, like a year apart? They look so similar. Like,
I got to actually babysit them growing up out at Fest. Like, babysit. Like, hey, you're babysitting now, and just go play, and, like, adults are kind of watching.
Yeah, I'll just make sure you don't stab each other. Yeah.
Yeah. They look so the incredibly similar as kids. And, like, it's...
Twins.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, did you just come back?
We just talked about
this.
This
is literally the thesis of the conversation.
Yeah, but only mansplaining that.
To be clear, I didn't say, well, actually, they're twins, Jenna.
Are you
as, hold on. As the two women over here can tell you that you don't need to say, well, actually, to be mansplained.
Yeah, there was
not how it works.
But no, like, the only way you could tell them apart when they were kids was one of them had a birthmark. Yep. And you had to look for it, like right on the nose.
Well, no, when I first started at Fest, we all worked front gate together, and I could never tell.
Yeah. And now it's like, now at least you're like, Oh, are they like a year or two apart? Like they do look very different, like different enough now. But like, yeah, back then there was no telling.
Yeah, because I met them when they were probably, what, 15, 16, something
probably
like that.
Probably about that.
And never could understand, which they took great joy in making fun of me for.
Yeah. By the way, they're like a few years younger than me. They grew breasts before I did, and it pissed me right the fuck off.
Jenna, I grew breasts before you did.
I know.
Literally the first words I ever said to my future wife was, "Hello, sister's name."
Oh my god!
Oh.
Oh.
Our relationship went upwards from there.
It had to.
Yeah.
So what you're saying is you set a low bar.
How did you recover from that?
So Eric, what are we doing?
So we have we have some challenges that have been coming in from one J. Ashton Green with a note that says, please do now as these were piling up. So I believe the request is that these are done during the podcast. So we're going to hit these. So first off, we have a snack that is going to salsa.
Ooh, salsa gets some mini Oreos.
We have a soda form for a Blue Sun Soda Shop donation. That soda is for one of the good sodas we were given.
Yeah.
So Matt gets a nice treat.
I get a birch beer made of cane sugar from Boylan Bottling.
I fucking love birch beer, you fucking asshole. I hate you so much.
I will share with you if you'd like. Okay. They're super good. Yeah.
Yes. All right.
I'm better now. Thank you.
Yeah, that's what's up.
So Jenna, you're full of ire towards Matt right now, right?
Yes. Oh, so much.
Wait. So there is a... as much as I want to do this, Jenna can't take the Bean Boozled beans because they may have coconut in them, and Jenna will die.
Close to it, yeah.
So,
as much as we want that, we want to be the cause.
We want to be the non-culpable cause.
Right.
God, and we rehearsed this.
That's the word.
And also, so there was a Bean Boozled bean for Jenna and a Jenna Young package for Jenna.
Oh my God.
The note is AON Chaos. Now, to clarify, one is making somebody pick a bean that is either tasty or not, and we have no idea. And the other one is letting someone give out five of them. There are six of us up here.
Oh,
Well, and
are you sure they didn't misspell AON cast?
I can't have one. No, I get this.
Yes, but Jenna, I'm going to point out there are actually... seven of us on stage.
I was just thinking about that. Hi, Kyle. Yeah. Kyle, why don't you pick one of those bad boys off of yourself?
For those listening on the audio stream later, Kyle is still on stage.
And then I'm looking. There are four other dudes on this stage. So
get him. Get him. Get him.
Yeah. Fucking well, actually, me without a well.
Yeah.
Motherfuckers.
Mansplain them beans, motherfucker!
This is either toothpaste or blueberry. I hate both of those things.
Yep.
Good.
You're welcome.
I've got spoiled egg.
Not me. I don't have to.
I had the spoiled egg. It's disgusting.
But someone has to take yours. Yeah.
Someone has to take mine. I thought that I had to have a different thing happen to me.
We can give you a kendo hit instead.
I think I will take the kendo hit.
Aww. Thank you.
Because you're
fuck you.
Come on.
No, I have five.
Because she gets to give out five to anyone.
I can give out five. But then there was the other one. So the five dudes get the beans. I'm getting a kendo hit.
More beans.
Lauren, you're welcome.
Thank you.
You've been sitting here like patiently listening to
all your Renfest stories that I have no association to because I don't work out at Renfest.
No, but to be fair, you do show up once a year, get adorably drunk,
yeah.
and come to our shows and tip pretty well. So
Lauren,
you're
good people.
Did you get stinky socks or Tutti Frutti?
I have no idea. It wasn't good, though.
Probably the socks.
They were probably the stinky socks.
Okay.
I don't know. I got...
Here's the thing.
Blueberry and I'm still pissed.
Yeah.
Oh, coconut.
Ah.
I got rotten egg.
See, that's why I don't get to have them because you got the coconut, and I've got no idea. Can I pick who's giving me the kendo hit?
Sure, but I should also note that this entire stack is kendo hits.
Whoa.
Oh, good.
Two.
So we have another one for Jenna.
I get two.
So Matt,
one.
Salsa, James, Lauren, and Eric. So we all get one, and Jenna gets two.
Whoa!
And I think
choose wisely.
You just want to line up? I can
Yeah.
I think that's the most fair.
Hold on, Eric. I can kind of see that slip. Is she still mad about Honeytown Season 2? I can't do anything about that.
yes, she is.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
All right. So let me clarify. And
should we continue?
First off, we should get a location that is a mic turned around with the person in front of it, so hopefully they can hear the hits.
Yeah, that's fine. All right.
So, yeah.
Yes. Visual joke on audio. All
right. So for James,
nobody fart.
James, your hit is for being new to AON.
Oh, God damn it! It hurts enough already. Oh.
Oh God.
It's really fun to mic this.
All right.
I guess I should get over
Salsa
it.
Is next. Salsa is for being the last original AON.
Yes. Oh, my God. All right, so Lauren?
Wait. It looks like Matt's on his
Matt's
way.
Matt's next?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do I need two? Right, stereo?
Yep. Yeah, surround sound. Matt's
is for leaving AON.
Here we are.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, my God, you went on the hard part. Motherfucker. James. Middle of the stick, not the end.
Lauren?
Yeah?
Where is News from Honeytown Season 2?
I'm Leslie Johnson, and I too would like to come back.
I'm Michael Vernon, and I don't believe she has any idea what she's talking about.
Is it weird that I'm spanking an octopus?
It's weird that we're miking
that at
it.
Some point.
Mine is also for Where is News from Honeytown Season 2, and Jenna has no comment, so...
No comment?
There is one for me.
Jenna's
two
off
for
the
Jenna
record.
Left, so let's
off
do
the
these.
All right.
While we're standing up and milling, I need to leave the stage for just a second. I'll be right back.
What? Oh, all right. Oh, God.
Salsa's
right.
Got to take
somebody
it down.
Mic
Duda.
This. somebody mic this. To
hold your hand and rub
Lauren,
your back.
Lauren, you got this? Yes.
Yeah, I'll hold your hair back while you poop.
To be fair, my hair is long enough. Sometimes I need to shift this shit, so.
Oh!
All right, I'm going to come get mine.
There's no good yes. onesies. No, yeah.
No, the that's onesies fair. Actually make it
what's
work.
What's that?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
I get Lauren, you.
The fuck?
Yeah.
Do this and I'll mic it.
All right.
Careful, that mic cord's only so long.
Play with
wait,
later,
I'm not left-handed.
So.
Yeah, that's smart.
I'm going to hit it in the back swing.
Oh, yeah, you are. Might get a twofer if you wind up a little.
you got it? Ready?
Yeah, sure.
Ah! Whoa. Okay.
That was right on the curve, like the undercurve.
Sorry, I'll aim higher.
Or it's like a lift.
It does. It lifts and separates.
Yeah.
I'm right after this,
Chucky
guys.
I mean, yeah.
My butt bounces. All
right. We found a use.
And the last thing we have from one.
Ow, my butt.
J. Ashton Green is.
Yeah, thank you.
Lauren.
Yeah.
Uh huh. You get bubble wrap.
Yay! Bubble wrap!
And the comment is technical difficulty replay.
Oh.
Oh.
And also of note, James.
Yes.
You also got bubble wrap.
Yes.
From Kyle.
Aww.
Sorry I wasn't in a puppet.
Oh my God.
He farted directly on me when we were standing backstage just before High Five Guys. I love you, Kyle. But damn it.
So thank you, Jay Ashton Green.
So also, what have you got in the box?
What's in the box?
Yes, I love you, audience.
I also have something for James.
Oh. Is it his birthday?
Merry Christmas to you.
No.
Merry
this is
Christmas.
A present, and while James reads the top, and I wonder if he gets...
Oh, no! I know exactly what this is before I even open it.
Yep.
Well, read it.
What does the top
it says,
say, maybe?
Merry belated Christmas, you filthy sauna bench. Sauna bench.
Is that like a sauna bench? Or
sauna bench.
Like a sauna.
Sauna.
Like
a yes.
Okay.
Sauna.
James unwrap this.
Okay, thank
how
you.
How many vowels are in that, James?
Sauna.
To be fair, as many as we need.
Is accent there? Oh, my God.
While James opens this, I will give a little bit of the backstory. James and I used to work at the same company.
Twice.
Wait, which one?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, okay.
Because, you know, I got him the job at the place that I still work at right now. And every Friday, we have something called Meat Club. And at Meat Club, one person brings the protein, and the rest of the people bring it. It's basically a potluck. But we call it Meat Club.
Ew.
Yeah. But one person, you know, and people sign up for the different dishes that they're going to. People sign up for the different dishes that they're going to bring for that week, and you know, of course, one person always brings the beverages. And one week, somebody brought a case of Coke Zero, and nobody touched it.
Yep.
And every single week after that, that case of Coke Zero went to Meat Club. And nobody ever touched it. And that single case of Coke Zero sat around for months. And finally, it became a running gag between
Jesus fucking Christ.
This guy and another one of our coworkers that they would give each other a delicious can of Coke Zero. And the other one would get to work the next day, and there would be two cans of Coke Zero at their desk.
Oh,
and the next day, the other person would get there, and there would be three cans. And it was an arms race. And so our coworker Ben has gifted you all of the Coke Zero that he has been stockpiling since you left the company.
Literally a lifetime supply. You know what? You know what? Ben, I love you, man. I'm going to crack one of these right now.
I am not joking, by the way.
Oh, my God.
He has literally been saving these since James left the company.
Holy crap. Well, and the best part about this is that we never just say it's a Coke Zero. It's always a cool, refreshing,
ice cold,
yes,
refreshing Coke Zero.
I want to point out it's not a big box.
No.
No, there are like
six cans
in
here. No, this is the thing.
He
had two 12-packs, and his wife gave them to her mother because she was like, you're never going to give it to this guy.
Oh.
And now he's like, no, I was. I was going to do that.
I had a patsy. All right, I'm pouring one out for my homies into my mouth. That counts, right?
Oh, God. This is not okay.
Wow, you're actually doing it.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
James?
The aspartame.
That tastes like love. That's what that is.
James, do you want to fortify that love with bourbon?
It can't hurt.
Bacon vodka, bacon vodka, bacon vodka, bacon vodka, bacon vodka.
You know what? No,
bacon,
my God,
vodka.
No. Someone has to pay for that.
How much is it?
Well, that's fair. That's fair.
No.
20 bucks?
Someone would have to pay for that.
Yeah.
20 bucks for one shot? Salsa's got it.
You're really?
Bacon vodka, bacon vodka, bacon vodka, bacon.
This is about to be a cherry bacon Coke Zero.
Yeah. Yeah,
just
do
a little.
It.
No, dude.
Yeah,
just
man.
No, that's way too much.
Yes.
That's enough.
I'm gonna say you ruined this Coke Zero.
Thank you, Jason.
Thanks,
Jason.
Wow.
How long were you supposed to be on this podcast?
I have seven more minutes. I have until 4:30. Okay. So glad I've been here. So quietly.
I want to let you know how much glee that I sincerely
let him know what happened.
There was I'm not joking when there was chuckling coming from his
witness
cubicle
him.
While he
all
was
right.
rapping that.
I will be shiny and chrome.
I do have a question, not to get into last names at all.
It's extraphobian so bad.
This coworker, does their last name does their last name start with an L?
It does.
Oh. Hi, Ben.
Oh. Yay. Oh, it
Excellent.
Lingers.
Ugh.
You remember when we were licking your foot as part of the vilification tennis thing?
Yeah.
Oh God.
This.
I
have figured out what your fucking foot.
No.
It's cherry Coke Zero and
bacon vodka.
Ooh, Matt, wash your feet.
You know that actually makes sense. To be
To be fair, those are some of the funniest photos ever taken.
No, they are. Absolutely.
They really are. Oh, poor Greg.
Right up there with fireball off your ass.
Oh, my God.
That was also pretty dope.
Yeah.
More scarring, but
I feel like after that conversation, I need to point out that fireball off his ass was an actual fireball.
Yeah.
not the drink.
Dude, I legitimately thought you had to take shots off his ass.
No, no, no.
And I was picturing it like, you know, like belly button shots where like you have to like slurp it out.
No,
like,
no, no,
I was like, dude.
When I say fireball, I mean
why are we skimming over this?
We're talking about literal fuel applied to my ass and a person blowing a fireball off of it, which, by the way, we should point out, happened twice. A year apart.
Fucking carnies.
I'm doing this.
Now I do blockhead and eat glass and shit. It's way safer.
Yeah,
you
it's
know, I actually,
oh, you upgraded.
Here, I want you to just have a sip.
Yeah, do it.
No,
do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Sip. 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 Sip.
Chug.
Chug. Chug. Chug. Chug. Chug. Chug.
Chug. Oh, wow. Actually, got a good swig in there.
Nope. Yep. Nope.
Thank you, Cedius.
Woo.
Oh, my God. Yeah, no. Yeah.
I want to point out that a flying bullet, squirrel right? just stole Salsa's dollar.
That was perhaps.
I also want to point out that I maybe have a power to like just like chant things to make them happen.
Can we all use that power last year to make Salsa do the half pumpkin spice, half.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Can we point out
Salsa!
That might be the
Salsa!
Most
chug, chug, chug,
no,
chug,
no, no,
chug.
No, I in reference to that, by the way, I swallow swords and eat glass and stick nails up my nose and eat fire, and that half pumpkin spice, half coconut thing.
I'm
going to speak
glass,
for the women of the table again. Swallowing's not great, but whatever.
So you want to try Matt's foot?
Nope. So if you've been listening,
real quick,
to
I want
to
address
you gotta
that,
pay
that,
for that
the flying squirrel picking up the money and running was perhaps the most majestic action. Because literally, from where we're at, it is all white light. We can't see anybody in the audience. So also, it's just foof.
That's a really good point.
The majestic flying squirrel in its natural habitat.
Yeah.
So you might have
Richard
Attenborough
went nuts on that.
You might have heard Matt and Salsa talking about some of the carny things they did earlier as part of a show that was here. So on that topic, I did stand up.
Mm-hmm. Bring it full circle to 45 minutes ago.
Welcome to the AON podcast. This is what we do, bitches.
Our tangents are fractal.
How will they hear you over my delicious bubble wrap?
Multiple microphones?
Well.
Yeah.
I feel.
Someone's using this for an ASMR video. We're fine. Yeah.
No, I wanted to talk about the Questionable Choices show.
Oh,
yeah,
yeah.
I want to hear about it.
That was awesome.
Thank you. That was terrifying.
My favorite part was neither of you.
unsurprising.
Because my
okay
favorite part,
that.
My
Speaking
favorite
of ASMR.
Part was Megan chewing the glass into the microphone.
That was I was God. So fucking hard.
It made my skin crawl off of my body.
That there was
what?
When we, so, for those that weren't there, you know, I didn't witness that part on the streaming or whatever. We did a sideshow thing, me and Salsa and Megan, and one part of Megan's shtick was to eat a light bulb.
Yep.
And so we had a lamp on stage that I flicked on and off a couple times. So you knew it was a real light bulb. Then I put it in a plastic bag and smashed it with a hammer.
A clear plastic bag.
So I just dropped it in a Ziploc bag, smashed it, and then just handed it to her. And she pulls out a hunk and starts chewing.
No. I have a
you
fucking
know the sound
problem
like
with
when
teeth
somebody
things.
Gets like a
things.
Kettle
Ugh.
Chip.
Yep.
Yeah.
So the really crunchy, like somebody bites onto a kettle chip without closing their mouth, and you get that big crunch.
Yep.
It's like that times 20.
And the audience is kind of murmuring like, ooh, and then she goes, and it goes fucking stone cold silent.
Yeah.
And Salsa and I are in the back, yes, yes, yes,
and then it's
yes,
like
yes.
2 seconds
no.
go by, then,
yep. As it takes her second bite. No, and we had discussed this, you know, before the show while we were planning and writing the show and stuff like that. And Megan was like, you know, I obviously won't be able to talk. You know, is somebody going to be able to do the talking? You know, for me while I'm doing that. And I was like, no. This needs to be dead silent.
And oh my God.
And you need to do
oh
that
God.
Right in front of the microphone.
It got
that
serious as
play.
A heart attack out here. God. It was so good.
Well,
you have to know that there were 5 people around and in the box office watching that tiny, they could have walked in here at any time, but they were transfixed.
It was that I think was where we got our probably our biggest payoff for the entire set was that moment.
I want to point out that
She first debuted the insectivore thing at
Give to the Max.
Give to the Max.
Yep. Yep.
Which Woo! One of my favorite conversations happened when somebody who had come to see the show had no idea what was going on and was looking at the list that was for that show. And like, you know, the sword swallowing block, that kind of stuff. They're like, okay. And then I get the question, what's an insectivore? And I went, so herbivores eat plants.
Herbs.
Carnivores eat meat.
Carn.
eat carnitas.
So insectivores eat. And then insects. There was just an awkward silence for a few seconds while they waited for me to say something and then went, oh. And that same person was in the very front row. Yeah.
Oh, really?
Oh, my God.
Watching everything until Megan walked
yes.
forward. And as soon as she started to explain that she was about to eat a tarantula, the person goes, nope. Gets up and walks to the back of the theater, just out loud, just nope. As everything's going on stage, just gone.
Yeah, I think the first time Megan did the insectivore thing, she did a tarantula and I think, what, just some grub worms, something like that?
Crickets.
Crickets.
I think. Hey, guys.
I believe she acts.
I'm leaving because it's been 60 minutes and my time is up.
Lauren, why don't you just hang out for another 60 minutes?
Are you?
Because that's $30, right?
Yes.
Well, that's going to happen.
Ah.
Oh, no, you got to keep hanging out and drinking.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Oh, no, 60 minutes of accent day.
Oh, no.
It's still accent day.
Accent day, accent hour, accent drinking.
And my favorite part after work is going to the bar for accent hour. The drinks are more expensive, but damn, does it sound funny.
It's all
imported, ooh la la.
And I want to point out that I believe it was an accident that she was right next to the mic.
It's accident day.
It's accident day. But she was talking, like she was explaining what she was about to do, and she didn't step back away from the mic, and she was still standing right there when she took a bite, and the crunch echoed through the entire house, and everyone went, "Huh."
You can believe that was an accident.
Oh. And then leaned into the mic for the second bite, like mouthful, like, ow. And just this big crunch, and everyone's like, ugh. And she's like, okay.
It was like a furry pork rind.
Oh, God. Oh, man, when you said furry.
No, that's the thing. A bunch of us, like a half dozen of us, were sitting backstage.
Lauren, furry pork rind, not furry pork grind.
My bad.
A half dozen of us were sitting backstage, and she walked through with it, and we were like, oh, that doesn't seem so bad. And then somebody was like, but what about all of that hair? And then everyone went,
oh! Oh, no.
I distinctly remember her opening the bag that it came in, and her going, oh, it's hairy, backstage, and everyone went, oh, let me see. And then looked at it, and when they looked at it and confirmed that it was hairy, they're like, oh, I'm out, and walked away.
The life of a sideshow carny is glamorous.
Yeah, there's a couple things that we actually had in the work. There's actually some insects downstairs we didn't even use today.
Yep.
And there's other things that we didn't quite have time to prepare. So there's more of that to come.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. No, when the next stunt that I have planned is going to make Matt hurl.
Oh,
God. Oh, good.
If we can pull off the one we talked about that Megan and I would do. There's some weird shit, dude.
No, I believe I explained to you why that won't work.
No, legitimately, we have a stunt that is in the works for Matt and Megan that I believe has never been done before.
It's because it's really dumb.
It is very dumb.
It is
stupid. So stupid and super dangerous, and I have a hard on just thinking about it.
So, Salsa, really quick, I also want you to know that during the Questionable Choices show, Nancy's nephew wandered up to the booth at the moment that you were putting the sword into your mouth, and he's like, oh, that guy's got like that's a trick sword. And I was like, nope, it's a real one. And he went, ah.
whoa. Oh. And I was like, hold. There's the bow. And he went, no.
Jenna, didn't you have a date like that once?
Lauren, I'd love
Lauren
to
earns
yes,
her $30.
I cannot swallow a sword like salsa can swallow a sword. I'm just
yeah, I did. I did.
Although I do,
you know, Jenna, practice makes perfect.
I do always bow at the end. So.
I had my parents and my son in the audience for that, which I hadn't intended. But
wait, Jenna's bow?
Wait, what? Yeah, for Jenna's bow? Exactly. They held up scorecards. My son's the Russian judge. But no, I had my parents and my son were in the audience while we did our sideshow bit. And I warned them that this was not going to be their cup of tea. The boy is super into it because he's watched us rehearse these things at home. So he knows how they all work and why they're dangerous and why he can't do them. Right. My parents do not like things that I do where I get hurt. Or even the appearance of me getting hurt.
Right.
So how do they go to any of your shows?
They honestly, how often do you see my parents at our shows?
That's fair.
Yeah, good point.
Right?
But to be fair, like honestly, he gets hurt more at Vilification Tennis shows than he did at this show.
Well, just to back that, Matt and I did Murder on the Mississippi together, where my character is just a total bitch to his character, and they fucking went after me
character.
For it. They were not having my character be mean to
super
him.
Super protective. Yeah, like they're delightful. They love me. And
for they're so
reason,
cute.
Yeah, my parents are the Cleavers. They're adorable.
Yeah.
But I was like, you know, it'd be cool if he could swim with the boy for a little bit because they had him for the weekend. And I was like, that'd be neat if he can. And he'd like this show. You guys, honestly, like, this isn't going to be your thing. It's like the sideshow stuff I do. And they're like, no, it's fine. We like supporting you and whatever. They left before I got back upstage from pulling the staples out and putting Band-Aids on. They were gone. Yeah. And the boy is just sitting here going, I'm not sure where Grandma and Grandpa went.
Yeah.
But they said you'd buy me lunch.
Oh my god, that's fantastic.
Because we got done, I had $112 stapled to me with a staple gun. And there's no gag on that, it's just a staple gun.
Yeah. And classic sideshow.
Yeah, so I just, yeah, like for those of you that are here in person, you can see. But the.
That has been simmering in there.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Oh, my god.
But if you're here, I'm just covered in little snake bites.
Yeah.
All over my body. And that we ended up making $112. I was surprised we made any.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's right. That's its own personal
I'm gonna bury
musk.
Myself in bacon vodka.
Good luck with
Whoa.
That. But they just dipped. And got bandaged up, got over being a little woozy from losing the adrenaline, and then went upstairs, got the boy, and he and Megan and I went out and had lunch. That reminds me, I have scotch eggs in the refrigerator downstairs. Fuck yeah. I know, right?
Not for long.
Son of a bitch. You don't know which fridge.
Where did you get
it? Literally, Red Cow.
I know which.
They're really good, too.
I'm going there.
Yeah, they're very good.
I know which fridge.
God damn it, you do. Anyway, so we come back from lunch, and my dad's like, hey, what time should we go with the boy? I'm like, I don't know, 2? 2's great. So they show up at 2. And they, I was like, oh, shit, Lyritics are about to go on. Austin would probably dig this, and my parents would probably dig it. They're really great. And they come in, and they're like, hey, Austin, like, do you have fun? He's like, yeah. And I'm like, hey, guys, do you want to hang out and watch the next show? It's a music act. I think you guys like it. They're like, no, we're good. So do you have fun, Austin? And I'm like,
I have a challenge to announce. We got a donation to put Jason and Kayla on the podcast for
the
next 60 minutes, which will almost take us to the end.
Nice.
I don't know what asshole
back.
Did it, but they did it on
the
60 minutes will take us to the
thank
end.
Thank you, anonymous donor.
Yay.
Welcome back.
We want Kayla over in the chick corner.
Chicks.
Oh, no.
Chicks.
Don't throw me in the briar patch, she says. So,
Matt, do I have a line on my face from the pillow? I was just
sleeping. You got to sleep, you motherfucker.
So I feel like I need to point out that the first time I met your mom was at...
Say it slow.
No.
No.
Was at like one of the... Renfest Mall of America things.
Oh.
And I no, absolutely not. And you were like, hey mom, this is Eric. He's the one that planned this thing, which was something that Matt did that was stupid. And she like stepped forward and put her fists up like she was gonna punch me. And then Matt goes, he also directs Honeytown. And she goes, oh, and then gives me a big hug.
Oh! I want the sound bite of what just happened right now. That's going to be my theme song. Ringtone is the rest of us doing like creepy, pornish kind of music and Eric telling a shitty story.
You know what? No more coffee for you.
She's got a good grip on that. Oh, no. Not good.
I have a delicious, refreshing Coke Zero if you want one.
It was only shitty in the context of the porn music.
That's
it wasn't
fair.
That the story itself was bad. Fine. Just with everything else going.
Keep your coffee.
I'm kind of tempted to try to get a few of us in a room and do a cover album of porn music.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Acapella porn music?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Oh, my dream.
This is an... Oh, wait. TM. We own this.
Oh, yeah. It's an album. It's an album called How Will I Ever Pay for This Pizza?
You guys.
Yeah.
No, like, serious.
This is an untapped market.
Shut the fuck up.
I can't.
Serious, you guys, for a second. Let's do this.
Oh, yeah.
I'm into this.
Right
yes.
Here,
I'm in.
Yeah.
I'm in.
I want... Okay. So we're all seriously... We're doing this right now.
I already have
right
the name. Clean
our, okay. Our album label is Untapped Market.
Okay, no.
I already
no.
have the
James,
name.
James. Yeah. Start this.
I
could not help it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
yes.
Buckle up for the sex.
We have been fuckapella.
A joke 8 years in coming.
I had a date like that once.
Right now I'm expecting to hear like...
I did go to music
as
school.
As Lyritic slowly snaps and walks in off the side of the stage. And then just smashes us and then walks away.
I would be so happy with that.
I would be happily defeated by Lyritic.
Oh, yeah.
I just want it to happen.
So do you think whoever bought these two back on here expected any of that shit to happen?
I don't know, but I'm so happy.
They're now implicit, probably. Though.
This would not have been the same without you. Oh, my God.
Is there decent booze anywhere? Do you have anything that doesn't suck?
God damn it.
The whiskey.
Oh,
Jesus. Yeah.
I have Four Roses.
Oh, whoa, the whiskey is on stage, yes.
Yes.
You do not get it for the shot challenge. I'll guarantee you that.
I asked if it was here.
It is in fact here. Yes, well done. All right. Oh, Matt's paper.
I feel like you need to type this all with a middle finger. Is what I'm thinking.
I want to point out that we have two lovely bottles of True Stone coffee. And one of them, we're almost all the way through, but that means we still have one full bottle of delicious cold press. So,
hey, do you wanna put a little of that in here so I can mix in some refreshing Coke Zero and bacon vodka?
No.
Why would you ruin coffee like that?
I'm hoping it will taste better.
No.
Look,
True Stone
is really good. True Stone is fantastic. In fact, True Stone is the best. But it's not fucking magic, all right?
I'm going to make this happen, though.
See, I want to point out that
Sheila's been wearing a onesie and do not have a credit card.
Would have put the shot of bacon vodka in a glass and then added some Coke Zero.
Nope.
Instead of making like 16 ounces of bacon.
Oh no! I tried to protest.
Hey Matt.
Did
you specify which alcohol you get a shot of?
No, I actually realized I'm wearing a onesie and don't have a credit card.
Yeah.
I was gonna say dealer choice.
Matt chanting. Enchanting, Manchanting?
Manchanting?
No, I don't like it.
So apropos of nothing. What do you want to talk
about?
I remember.
Someone trying to get a podcast back on the rails?
I know, right?
Hey, Lauren, what have you been up to?
What is rails?
What is this?
I've been coordinating hosts for Die Laughing.
Ooh. Oh my God, I'm sorry.
Can you say that in a more accent there?
Oh, you know, I've just been up to coordinating hosts for Die Laughing Marathon going on April 6th through 8th.
Damn, are accents like it, just meaning talk loud?
Can I just, by the way, say her idea of accent is talk really loud?
If I scream in mic, I'm from somewhere.
Wait, wait.
Ladislavia!
So you have participated in an accent day before.
Oh, yes, yes, I have.
I'm just going to go ahead and say, do fuck yourself.
Do. Do fuck. Do fuck, Kyle.
That is Fuckapella's number two track.
That's when we went commercial and sold out.
It needs to be more angry in German.
Do fuck yourself. Man, anyone that's tuning in right now is going to be really confused.
They're like...
No, they're going to flip to the channel. They're going to be like, seems right. Next.
Somewhere, somebody is slowly falling asleep to this, being like, man, Stranger Things got real weird.
No, someone's going, fuck it, it's too much Pornhub, I gotta go.
You know,
even better, somebody is just waking up and going, what is going on?
So Katie, like, just got off work. And she's like, I should check in on Die Laughing. And opens it up and sees, dude.
God
damn it.
Speaking
Would
of which,
you like making fuck berserker?
If I may take a quick moment of sincerity, one of the things I do actually miss from doing AON and hanging out with the High Five guys more frequently is there's a certain number of international listeners that I hear from less frequently who still support us during Die Laughing and are fucking dope because there's many times they're the only people awake because why else would you be? Because they're time shifted 10, 12, 15 hours, whatever it is. And they're the ones that are often watching us do this live. Yeah. So thank you if you're one of those people. Yes, we truly love that and appreciate it.
And I, along those lines, I have to point out that we did improvise Twilight Zone yesterday at this point.
Yeah.
Almost
12
time.
Hours ago.
Yeah. So 24.
God damn it!
Atta girl, Lauren.
It's okay.
So
it's okay.
We had a 6:30 a.m. show. Yeah. So I had my wake-up call at 5 because there's no way I'm waking up quickly. And I walk up here, and it was Heather Zastera, who is currently still on
tech.
And I walk over, and I'm like, how are things going? And she goes, oh, the Canadians are discussing things. And apparently they still are.
Oh my God. Can we do a song for the Canadians?
And that was when I looked at things, and it was like... It was saying things
sorry.
Like,
sorry.
I like how that my, the name that they're going to see isn't the same name they know me by, so they don't necessarily know it's me donating to them. And very, like, Minnesotan passive-aggressive, like, I'm going to give them punishments, but they won't know it's for me.
Done.
Yep.
Oh.
Yeah. Ashton.
We might have seen a fuck ton of those during the course of this podcast.
A lot about Honeytown. God damn it.
By the way, I'd just like to point out, there are international people right in Canada and Australia and other places, England, that have been watching and donating, so what's your excuse?
Yeah.
Ooh.
That Midwestern guilt.
I don't know if I ever said thank you to AON, but you actually netted, when the awful copter, the 4 years that we ran, you netted us one of our best listeners. Stefan Senpai.
Yeah.
We got his attention in the middle of the fucking night during one of these Die Laughing marathons. It was, in fact, our first Die Laughing marathon during which I recited the clown joke. And we just got a tweet back that was, what the fuck did I just watch? And then he stuck with us for another 3 years.
That's astounding.
Yes. So I have AON to thank and Die Laughing to thank for our beautiful Stefan Senpai.
So thank you, and I'm very pleased to be a part of the shenanigans.
So what's the best show you've seen so far?
Thank you.
What's the best show you've seen so far, Matt?
Oh man, that's rough.
We have to pick one. Pick one we're not in, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Dope.
Yeah. That narrows it down significantly.
I gotta tell
you. Hold on. Were you gonna pick your own show as like your favorite?
Not. It can be. It can be a show you were in, as long as you know. If,
if you weren't producing.
Like yeah. Exactly.
Like
exactly.
Sync,
exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
That's real tough. If it's something I'm 100% not involved in, I honestly gotta say it might be Fraudini.
Oh yeah.
Because I that dude. God damn it. Somehow, fucking if there was like a bat phone to my funny bone, that dude's got it. It destroyed me. It was so goddamn good. And this is not to insult anyone else, because there's so much great work. If it's a show I was at least tangentially involved in, the one that I hate to admit it because it scared me so much, but it was really fun once I got on stage and it was too late to be scared, was doing White Male Privileged Dancers again.
Oh, yeah.
I hate that show because it's so scary. But I love doing it once I'm on stage. So that's a big thank you to Jenna for creating that show.
Yes.
I'm super happy. Oh, by the way, thank you for that. I hate producing that show so hard. Like I don't like watching my friends get naked.
Yeah. To be fair, I was completely clothed this year.
That was my college experience.
But it's like people that like I've known for like as long as I've known Jessa and or longer, just like taking their clothes off in a sexual way. I'm like, gross. But also it's like it's the one show that I produce for Die Laughing that I'm not like coordinating everything out. It's my one production. Mm-hmm. I don't have the time for that shit. Mm. I'm busy trying to pull together like music files and
stuff.
Yeah,
dude, shit takes effort.
Oh yeah.
Fuck you.
Nah, I don't care.
Also, that show came. Oh, sorry.
Go ahead.
I was just gonna say that show came from AON.
It did.
Oh, that's right.
From show,
you two fuckers were like, I could do burlesque better.
Yeah, and I'm that like, was a dick measuring contest that turned into a show.
The two of you were
it turned into a show where the audience could measure your dicks.
I will say I appreciate that it's evolved so far beyond the initial idea of like, wouldn't it be silly if? And now it's like, oh, this is actually like, it's much like Epic Lip Sync.
Oh, yeah.
It's very performative and very competitive.
It's really deeply cool. Impressed.
Yeah.
It's super fun.
I love that it's kind of gone beyond the and it's more like people are putting serious thought and effort into this and trying out new forms of it. We had ballet.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
Fucking
dope. That was so beautiful.
Yeah. That was really great. Yeah.
Yeah. No, I love that it gives white dudes an opportunity to express themselves in a different way and like express comedy in a different form than they're used to doing. I think that's fantastic. Mm-hmm.
Salsa, are you about to ruin this?
Because white dudes need more opportunities.
emotionally, yes, kind of, actually.
To be fair.
I'm not... Like in being able to express themselves in artistic, pretty, and emotional ways. That's the one place where you guys are lacking.
I absolutely loved being a part of that show the couple years that I was in it.
Yeah.
I offered when you were trying to find people this year.
Yeah.
And I said I could do the show, but it is the only time that I have more than a 5-hour block that I could actually sleep this weekend.
Yeah.
And Jenna said, no. You're not allowed to do this show. Mm-hmm.
Right. Your idea was astounding, and I hope to see it. I hope to take part in it.
Eric, I will also say I have not had a 5-hour block of sleep at all.
No, I didn't say I slept. I had a 5-hour block where I could sleep.
Oh, fuck you.
God damn it, man.
All right.
Who's next?
Let's interject really quick. I got a soda.
Woo.
Nice.
From J. Ashton Green.
Yes!
It is a cherry strawberry.
The comments say, fuck a Pella.
Oh, yay!
I also got...
First album sold. Bandcamp, here we come.
I got a snack myself from J. Ashton Green, which also says, fuck a Pella.
It's already putting food on our table.
hey, Matt.
Oi.
Guess what I got.
Oh!
I got
had a bag of gushers as a thing yesterday, but I gave it to the boy this morning.
It's gonna be like his Yoko.
No. Well, you know what, Matt? You shared your birch beer with me.
Aww.
It's true. It's true, I did. So you're gonna say fuck off.
James, favorite show so far?
Pass this one down. Nice. It's already drippy, so have fun.
Favorite show
Let's
so far
handle it on the way.
Is
yep, please do.
Probably. Oh God.
That's the next song.
Yeah, Jason.
Oh yeah.
I'm actually gonna do both hands.
Two-fisting it.
There we go.
James,
now,
favorite show.
My favorite show so far has been this one.
Really?
I fucking love you guys. I listened to both of your shows long before I was on either of your podcasts, and now that I am involved. Now that I am the uncle in the picture, I fucking love it.
You are already on the show. You don't need to suck up anymore.
I know, baby. It's just a service I provide.
Eric.
Yes, Jenna.
Yes.
Yes. That's
never
fair.
Make him. Don't never but let him get complacent. You can be replaced. Yep. Trust me, you can be replaced.
My favorite joke from our podcast was when Salsa wasn't there for a week, and we were like, we always said Salsa could be replaced. But we never knew before that he could be replaced by nothing.
Fuck. Yeah.
That was a good week, too.
I think our listenership. Number of downloads, and yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Jason? Eat that mic.
So, for me, I got... Due to the fact that I've been running streams so much, I get to watch pretty much everything. But... One of the ones that makes me really want to see it come back is Bad Advice with Siri.
That was
so good.
Holy shit!
The delivery.
Oh
yes.
Yeah, and like not just from the lady in the box, so the Siri and Alexa, but also Jason's component to it. Like the entire thing was absolutely brilliant.
As
Jason
a trio.
Plays hapless very
Oh,
absolutely.
As a trio, those three are fucking amazing.
It was really funny.
Yeah, when they cast that show, they did that perfectly. The Fearless, that was the from the Five, right?
Yeah, that was my show.
That
from
was
the
show Eric directed.
Yeah,
it was written by
your casting
Keith
was
DeLune.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Keith, another often unseen but
Izzy,
wildly
Kyle?
Valuable member.
Carl.
of
Kelvin.
Kelvin, you're right. I'm sorry. Kelvin. An unseen but incredibly valuable member.
Kanye.
Of Fearless. Kanye.
My
Samsonite.
Favorite part about that group is
Samsonite.
As we were playing things,
it's right here on the back.
All I really had to do was aim them.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like when they did something and I'm like, all right, let's do more of this. Mm-hmm. Or like... When you got mad and you went in this direction and did that thing, keep that and do that again. And it was mostly just like, all right, play with it and let them kind of have some freedom and then go, all right, this is what we need.
Here's your motivation.
I've learned most of directing is proper casting. Mm-hmm. Mm. If you get the right people, they'll just do their
job. It's like 90% of the job is just casting the right people.
Let people do what they do.
Yeah.
It's great. Mm-hmm. Salsa?
I already said mine.
Did you?
It was Fraudini and Mary Jo Peele.
Oh yeah,
those both like, strong.
They were both very.
I love
fucking amazing.
So much.
No, like I actually like I had my wife and I have been texting over the weekend and of because we haven't seen each other and I was talking. I was like, you know, I'm actually after 7:30 my shifts are done and I'm going to be able to get some sleep. And then I was like, okay, it's time to go to bed at 7:30. And then I looked at the schedule and went, Mary Jo Peele.
You got up from two seats over from me and was like, all right, guys, I got to go to bed. And then 3 minutes later, sat back down and was like, fuck, it's Mary Jo Peele.
Yep. Yeah, no. I left to go catch as much sleep as I possibly could because it was my first opportunity in a very long time. And I got there and I was like, how much time do I have to sleep before my next show? And I was like, wait, I'm going to set an alarm to wake up and watch the stream for 30 minutes to catch Mary Jo Peele.
Yep.
And then I'm going back to sleep before the next show.
Yeah. No, she destroyed
It was so good.
Yeah.
It was like, I'm going to bed, and I see Mary Jo Peele on the schedule, and I'm like, okay, so I walk back in the theater, and it's Matt and Megan and our friend Tanya are sitting there, and all of them look at me with a quizzical look, and I just point at the stage.
Yeah.
And they all go, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Fair enough.
So I have to say that, unfortunately, because of the way my schedule worked out this year, I could not see Mary Jo Peele.
Oh.
But I do remember that a few years ago when she first joined us, Matt was backstage
hotel.
when our backstage was basically we had the curtain and then a space behind the curtain where we could put
so
a few
basically
things.
If I was 4 feet that way.
Yeah. And Mary Jo Peele was doing her set, and during her set she would tell a joke, and then from this like aimless place behind her there would be this cackle where Matt heard the joke, and she would look back and be like, okay.
I think she thought it was. I think she actually thought I was fucking with her at first, and then
someone back there liked that one. And
yeah.
So I'm sorry I missed it, but
one of my favorite
sets
of hers.
Sometimes you just have.
Yeah. She finally on that night she finally poked her head through the curtain and was like, "Are you all right?" And I was laying on the floor laughing, and then she went and she smiled like, "Okay," because she realized I was actually laughing. I wasn't just being a prick.
Eric, what was your favorite show?
You said it's a show that we watched, right?
We weren't really involved in, but didn't produce. Part of the show that you were in that you were not involved with.
So a show that I mostly watched is Lounge Lizzie.
Oh my God.
Oh yeah.
Because realistically, realistically for that show, my character is the stage manager, and I do the intro, I handle logistics, I keep things moving. But mostly
you have
my
the third
job,
hardest job.
Oh no!
Yeah. You want to explain that?
Yeah, you have to keep a straight face. Actually, yeah, on that stage, I would say that is almost the hardest fucking job.
Right.
So there was one point where Aaron is singing something and they're doing like weird like.
They're like.
Yes.
He's fucking cold.
And I believe what Matt said to me was he's like, I was staring you down. And I was looking at you, and I was laughing, and I was going, why the fuck aren't you breaking, you motherfucker?
Yes.
And I'm sitting there going like, nope. Mm-mm. And just like, I cannot break. This has to be just, I've seen this 1,000 times. This is just how this song goes. And God damn, that is
it was
such
glorious.
A lovely show.
All of the bacon vodka has settled to the bottom of this bottle.
Not okay.
So
this one's for Jenna.
Oh, why is there a stick?
You should read it, Jenna.
I should read it.
And you should come over here so we can eat.
Thanks, Becky.
Oh, shit.
What does it say? What does it say?
You reference visual comedy for an audio medium.
Oh, gotta pay the tax.
Oh, God, you gave it to me. Kyle, you gave it to me backwards, you motherfucker.
Yeah. I gave it to Eric.
To Jenna from Becky, I told you, you have to credit me if you reference visual comedy for an audio medium.
Oh. It's fair. I got the mic up so we can get a good good thwack on this. Are you right or left-handed?
Jenna's butt.
White male comedian. I'm taking everything.
I'm taking credit for everything.
But I'm not a
I know.
I think I saw a lip sync battle about
that. You can put butt AV on your resume now, Matt.
This might get me an IMDb.
Did you know I have an IMDb entry and it sounds like porn?
What does that sound like?
I believe you are intimately familiar.
Oh, God.
Wow.
As part of Fuckapella.
Yeah.
She truly pimped you for an opportunity to create a new porn song.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Woof, swinging a
Jesus.
Miss.
Jesus, you complimented me earlier for being able to pick up and start. No, it's fucking too late.
The moment
is
passed.
It is too late. It's done. It's done, James.
I'm so sorry.
This is the man. I wish someone would take me.
No. All right. Let me make it better by telling you what the entry on my IMDb is for.
Fine.
It's a film called Necessary Lubrication.
All right, Jenna. What's your favorite?
Yep. All right.
Bubble
wrap.
So I loved Lounge Lizzie, but I was actually on stage for a few of that.
That was good.
There was the bidding war between myself mm-hmm. and Kyle, and then he bought me.
It was delightful.
Lounge Lizzie's song, and I don't know, man. I think somewhere in between her rubbing herself up against me and like putting her lips just like a centimeter away from mine, like this microphone barely keeping us apart. Or was it when she was in my... Look, it was a really good show, is what I'm saying.
Yeah, she does that.
Damn.
Yeah, that was good. I actually have not seen much this Die Laughing. I've been fixing issues and things like that. It's all small shit, but it's all the behind-the-scenes stuff. I was going to make time for a couple of shows that I just didn't get to see. However, there are a couple of shows that I absolutely positively had to see and made time for, and there was no... Justice shows.
Fuck yeah.
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 Mm-hmm. Yeah. She did Official Ostrich Committee. They've started playing with, like, extending their scenes.
Nice.
Hmm.
And they had some really good fucking scenes and some incredible callbacks with that. But I gotta say, Vilification Tennis.
Dude.
Oh, yeah.
Watching my daughter fucking tonight. Own that stage was brilliant.
She was savage fire.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit.
She was like, I'm 17 and I'm not taking shit all from fuck all y'all.
It was good.
God damn.
It was so good.
A friend of mine showed up who had never seen the show before, and all I could hear the entire time your daughter was on stage was him going, oh, holy shit.
Which in Vilten is sweet.
Yes.
honestly, like, this is not the reason I retired from Vilten.
Oh, this is absolutely the reason I retired.
But I am happy that I did when I did.
Yeah, because, I literally leaned over to, I was sitting by Megan and Tanya and a couple other people, and I was like, this is why I quit. I couldn't make this good. It would be worse if I was up there.
Yeah.
They don't need me.
Right? And I was there people over the past few years.
They're destroying it, and I'm like, I'm watching it going, I am baffled by what's happening. It's all hoots and clicks to me. I can't do this anymore. Yeah, yeah.
I know,
like the old man on the Twitter. Like,
yes!
Yeah. I know that Jenna teases me about being second place. About being second place to Jessa, but that's a pretty sweet fucking gig. She's
is,
really
right?
good.
Yeah. There's no shame in that gig.
Yeah, no, no. Holy shit.
I think watching Vil, number one, just being able to watch a Vil show and not have to worry about being a vilifier for that hour was nice. It's nice to get outside of that perspective and be like, all right, this is what the audience is looking for. But yeah, also just the mama pride of, that's my daughter saying that filthy shit on stage and owning it. Like, yes. I mean, that was, but yeah, I really haven't seen as much of the rest of Die Laughing as I would like. And I mean, that's a little sad. Like, I'd like to see more, but I'm also making things go for other people so that they can see more, so I don't feel awful about it. Like, that's kind of my thing. I like doing that shit, so.
Well, that's, I think almost all of us have done either tech shifts or hosting shifts or whatever, and, like, you don't really get to sit and enjoy
hosting shifts.
Right. But, like, but the point is you're facilitating the fun for other people, and that is very rewarding.
Yeah.
You know, like, I'm sad because there are people that even during my hosting shift, I saw maybe 4 minutes of.
Wow.
You know, and it's like, that's a drag because they were really good, but, like, you're busy checking in with the next person, and someone's going, hey, do you know where the, maybe over here. And, like, it's a drag on a personal level for not being able to just be an audience member. But if no one does that, then there is no show. I'm happy to be able to be part of it, even if I don't get to have the full sit back and just
Monty.
Enjoy the splendor of what it is.
The full Monty.
I was Montague hoping to make time to you. I really wanted to see that, and I was all set to go, and then there was an issue that came up, and I'm like, son of a bitch. Well, all right, I'm handling this.
Yep.
Can we just...
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Go ahead.
Can we just take a moment and give Jenna a round of applause?
Yeah. Oh, fuck yeah.
For fucking... organizing this whole fucking thing.
I'm still going. I don't give a fuck.
I had a date like that once.
Where you got the clap?
That just kept going.
It just kept going, but also.
And she got the clap,
I need to have a conversation with a few people later. Yeah, no, that was okay. Thank you. Somebody else needs to talk now.
Hey, Lauren, what was your favorite
there
show?
You go.
I think just because
I've never seen you do stand-up before. I think your stand-up set might have been it. Because, like, I've seen... Eric, I've heard you say funny shit before. But, like, never in that same format, you know?
Right.
Like, it's different watching somebody put together a show than it is just hearing somebody be funny, like, out and about.
That was the thing we talked about earlier, where I got to watch people's sets get pieced together.
Yeah, exactly.
I got to watch Eric do parts of that.
Right.
And see how they changed. And so suddenly when he's doing a half hour, I was like, I don't know all this material, but I see the arc of it.
I am from what has brutally sad to have missed it.
Yeah, and I mean, it was a solid half hour.
Dude, I was so proud of you. It was so fucking good.
I tried so hard to be here for it. I'm sorry, man.
I hope I didn't ruin it with my hyena laughter from the back.
If you didn't, I did with my shriek.
We should point out, we talked about how cool Keith is earlier.
Yes.
Ah, cool Keith. But he might have died. He may still. He was hanging over there at the railing near the back doors by the sound booth.
Fuck yeah!
Just losing it. Because if you ever, by the way, if you ever have the time and money to pay Keith to be at your show to laugh at you because you're funny, do it. Because there's no better laughter to have at your show than Keith, because he is like the happiest, most gentle and kind person that truly enjoys laughing at funny things. And he was just wiping tears and slapping the railing and like slouching down, like holding himself up, laughing so hard. And he and I are looking at each other like, what the fuck? So he may still be laying over there 20 feet from us. I don't know. I hope he's okay. But he may have just laughed himself into a coma.
Did he die laughing?
Oh, shit.
Oh!
We did it!
Oh, no. Are we done?
We
have reached in
5 years later.
Poor Kevin!
We finally did it.
Damn it, Cornelius.
I don't realize what joke did it. It might have been the dessert joke, because that's still one of my
favorite. Still one of my favorite jokes you've ever done.
Yeah. And I'm more than happy to say it. It's,
please.
It's like I like going to dinner with people who like to order and split a dessert. Then I get 1.5 desserts. And the amount of that joke, and the amount of laughter I got meant that I couldn't continue my set.
Oh shit!
Because I love that moment during something where you tell a joke, or you like whether it's improv or stand up or anything, that you say something and the audience starts laughing and they laugh so hard that you can't help but laugh that they're laughing at your stuff, and it's like you're trying to continue but you're trying not to laugh. And it's just one of those beautiful
moments.
It's
a rare and beautiful moment.
And I have to say that, and it has been my experience between Lab and Die Laughing, that honestly, the audiences we get at Fearless shows are the best audiences you could ever ask for.
Yeah, for sure.
Yes. Starting at the other end of the table,
we still have one more to go.
Hey, you what up?
Yeah, but real quick.
Yeah.
I've been talking to other people about stand-up, and they've told me things like, oh, you should do a set here because the audience sucks, and it'll teach you how to fail.
Oh.
And, like, they won't want to laugh and things like that. And it's like, sure, I want to learn, and I want to develop my craft, and I want to know how to deal with these things. But hearing people actually come to me and tell me, like, oh, if you go here, the audience is going to hate you.
Huh.
The audience will never respond to you, and things like that. And then thinking about all the audiences we get at Fearless shows who are there to support the acts that are going up and know that the acts are trying something they've never done. They're trying things that they may not be practiced in, or things they've just newly written and just want to get in front of an audience. And our audiences are willing to go out there and go, okay, this may not be something that's polished. It may not be something that's finished. But I'm going to take this for what it is, and I'm going to enjoy it. And I'm going to laugh when I feel like laughing. And I'm going to respond when I feel like responding. Like, they don't go out and go, all right, impress me, and then cross their arms and try to defiantly not laugh. They go out and they enjoy the things that people put on. Mm-hmm. And the people that go out there put on things for an audience that appreciates them. And it is such a beautiful thing.
Yeah.
Agreed. Kayla?
Kayla.
A favorite
show that you either saw or were tangentially involved in?
Honestly, I think, I honestly think it was the sideshow for Salsa and Megan and Matt.
Aww.
Because It woke me up more than coffee did.
Whoa.
I was cringing so hard throughout and having to take pictures of it, basically. And it you know, it stuck
out.
One of those
will be my new profile pictures. Me, it's covered in dollar bills with a 50 on my stomach.
Dollar bill, y'all.
Oh, I was one of the 20s. But that was, I think, probably my fave, just because it was, yeah, like I said, it was kind of that waker upper, that mix of like total just cringing, watching these things happen and just like dying, you know, and complete entertainment. So that was probably nice. My favorite.
Aww. Thank you.
Yeah.
I wanted to say, speaking of places that you will bomb, worst comedy show ever. Young Eric, you are so fucking funny. I was prepared. Like, I knew what was about to happen, and it was even better and worse than I had hoped.
For the record, I didn't know what was about to happen.
Oh, shit.
Because the original plan was to prepare index cards and then go out there and drop the index cards and just pick them up and read whatever was on them,
right,
and then just kind of riff off of it.
When
I was like preparing stuff here, there were two things on my to-do list that sat there untouched until the last minute.
Oh.
One was my stand-up set, because that terrified me.
Yeah.
And the other thing were these index cards, because I kept going, oh, I can do that later. And then, I can do that later. We're here, the show has started, I can do that later. Then finally I get to sleep and I go, hey, Keith, you're staying awake for a while, right? He's like, yeah. This is what I want on these index cards. Can you fill these out? And he goes, oh, yeah. So I wake up, and the entire case of like 300 index cards
Holy
is
shit.
Covered.
Oh, yeah. Dude,
he's and it is, so it is, good. It has been, they've all been written on, and they're put back in the case. And I looked at it and went, I'm not opening that.
No.
Yes.
Yep.
So when I walked on stage, the only thing I saw was the top one.
Oh, fuck.
And that's it.
God.
I had no clue what any of those cards said.
God, that's good.
And the first one I drew after I dropped them and went, oh, was, if the audience doesn't laugh.
Yes!
That's on them. And I went, okay. Proceeded to do the worst 5 minutes
Fuck.
Of my life, which were draw a card and then go, this thing.
Jesus Christ, it was Kane amazing.
Card.
When in doubt, do the hokey
Fuck.
Pokey.
Yeah, and sometimes he would just look at the card and then start doing the hokey pokey very slow. Fuck, it was so good. God, and Keith, who knew what was on the cards, was dying over on the side. Again.
Can you imagine? He's the puppeteer of the whole
yeah.
thing. Of course he's dying
yeah.
laughing.
He
oh,
down.
Our sweet Kelly.
Granny Clampett. What the fuck, man?
I think my favorite moment was near the end of your set. You picked up a card and it said, don't forget to use the card. Just read it. Fuck you.
Done.
Oh, shit. Jay, you had a question that you wanted to start the other
time. Yeah, I was going to say, you're all fantastically funny people. Starting down at the other end, was there ever a time when you got an unexpectedly big reaction to something that you did?
Like ever or this event?
I'm going to say in your career.
Oh, buddy.
So, not like, well, fucking, but...
Oh, never mind then.
No, that's never happened.
I'm aware. I've been there for some of it.
Somebody's got to run the video camera.
For me, okay, the first time I did any kind of a stand-up, anything, which was at Die Laughing Woo! Last year at Lab... Because Matt was like, hey, you should do this thing. And I was like, I don't think I'm funny. And I remember like writing this song and then going around to like my coworkers and being like, this is funny, right? Like these things are funny. And they were like, yeah, that's funny.
Oh.
And I was like, okay, good. And I had no idea what to expect because I'd never done anything even remotely like that before. And so then I was like, okay, I guess I'm just going to go do this thing. And
it hadn't really occurred to me like what die laughing was per se.
Yeah.
So I show up and I'm like, oh, this is like a thing. This is like a 50-hour thing. And like there's this big audience, and I didn't actually know that it was being like live on the internet, which is cool because that's effectively how I came out. But anyway, so I ended up playing this song that's just kind of lovingly called the gay song, and I mean I guess it worked because I heard all kinds of laughs from the audience, and that kind of marked the start of here I am now. So there's that.
I just want to interject. We only have like 5 to 10 minutes left, so we should get through these.
Oh, quickly. Word.
Okay. You said ever, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, so in college, we did a production of The Hormel Girls, which was originally done at the Minnesota History Museum, and then we got the second rights to it. Huh? So I played the Southern Belle character. I don't even remember exactly what the phrase was, but it was, I said a line, somebody else said a line, and then I, like, my thing was kind of a joke, her thing was a response, then my second thing was kind of a joke. And I don't remember what the exact wordings were, but, like, our opening night, a lot of people who like produced the history theater like came to it, and so like we were pretty packed, and I remember like delivering those two lines and both of them getting big laughs and also having to figure out the spacing between them and having that be like my first real lesson in letting something breathe and figuring out the exact timing of it.
Nice.
Yeah. My biggest reaction, I think that I was not expecting, was directing the Fearless Five 2 years ago.
Yeah.
for the Harbingers, I got to do the sexy Harbingers of Doom.
Oh, that was fun.
I hope I'm thinking about this.
I think you are thinking about it. And I had three separate disapproving people that entered from three separate areas. one of those areas that one of them entered from was not an area that people expected him to enter from. There was a stage left and a stage right at Mounds Theater, but there the curtain split in the middle, even though there is like no backstage back there.
Yeah, there's stage left, stage right, and stage what the fuck.
Yeah, stage haunted. That's what it is.
Basically, well, it was about haunting, so it all worked perfectly. But the thing is that at the beginning of that 15-minute show, I had the Reverend Matthew Kasson behind the center curtains where nobody would ever enter or exit from because there is like a foot and a half of space there, and then just fuck you. So like I had one person enter from stage left and then one person enter from stage right, and that was all understandable. And then like these two go to walk upstage, and like suddenly there's Kesson, who has been there for like the past 10 minutes just waiting for his opportunity, and the audience lost their shit.
Yep.
Yeah.
And it
having
broke
seen it
my
yep.
actors,
yeah.
Yep. And it was fucking brilliant, and I was just like, oh god, I thought that was gonna be I didn't expect this, holy shit. Yes, I'm a genius. Like, yeah. So I think that's probably my biggest reaction, like unexpected reaction to
nice.
That I plotted.
All right. So a little bit savvy. I think my most unexpected reaction. So like Matt, I have stage fright. Getting on stage a lot of times is not an easy thing. The audition for Vilification Tennis is to do the show. And basically, I had argued my way into a corner trying to figure out a way to not do this. And when we got there on the night, I was terrified.
Honey.
I should also mention that my wife, having known me for such a long time and having to share a house with me, does not find me funny.
It's not bad.
My wife either.
I know. So
they're not wrong.
None of my any wives find me funny.
So anytime she likes a joke, it always bombs. And any joke that she doesn't like seems to go over well. So leading up to this, I had this feeling of like, nothing I have is funny. And I stepped on stage, and like 3 or 4 seconds into the conversation, the audience loses it. And I just kind of looked out and was like, I can do this. And I think that was the most unexpected and reassuring response that I've ever gotten.
Nice.
All right, we've got 30 seconds to get through everything.
I've been doing this for close to 2 decades, and I'm still astonished anybody laughs at anything I say. I think the what? You don't get it. I think the moment, the only one that springs to mind right now is we were doing a vilification tennis show a few years back, and I don't remember the exact theme. It was like hipsters or something. I think it was hipsters was the theme.
Sure.
But I came up with this idea where I was going to wear a guitar on stage.
Oh, God.
Shit. And every single insult I threw, I would start with, your mother is so fat, wrote a song about it.
God damn it.
And then I would play a terrible song with that. That was the punchline. And the first couple ones, you know. And then the third or fourth or fifth time I did it, it was like, oh, this is going to be a thing. And then the 10th or 11th time I did it, it was just because they knew it was coming. And so it would, you know, this, your mother is so fat, pregnant pause.
Abortion.
I wrote a song about it. And they knew it was coming. And it would be just, wrote a song about it. And they would lose their
God
shit.
God damn it.
So good.
Love it.
So for me, I'm not as as a practiced funny guy as everyone else. Funny guy, funny person.
Thank you.
So whenever, I get people to bust a gut, it makes me feel pretty good. But one of the times that comes to mind is it was shortly after I had joined Fearless and we were doing the hot sauce challenge.
Oh, God. Oh, fuck that. Fuck.
And with the hot sauce challenge, someone had to cancel out, so therefore that naturally meant the camera guy officially came over.
Comedy.
And porn.
So it was either the last hot sauce or the second last hot sauce, and I saw this dot on the chip, and I was looking on it. At it, and I looked up, and I'm like, I just realized that I joined Fearless 2 weeks too early.
Oh, shit!
and the entire room
was Fuck. Cosplay, wrote a skit. Link is being followed around by Navi. This is going to make sense to some of you and not others. I had a sound clip of the sound that plays when you grab something and he holds it up. And then the announcer was given a snippet to read. And so I'm wandering around and Navi's bothering me. And all of a sudden the sound plays and I hold this roll of duct tape aloft. And the crowd fucking exploded. And if there is video of it, I am sure that you can see me like wince away from the audience. Because I am stunned by the grenade of applause and cheering and shit, because I expected people to laugh. I was not at all prepared for that shit, and I have never achieved that degree of comedy ever again, but I will try.
I have
a
Viltan.
That's all the time that we have.
Oh, you piece of shit. I got a Viltan moment as well. It was maybe my first year, maybe my second year. Long enough ago that I was up against TJ and whoever his partner was at the time, which for those of you that watch Viltan, don't know who that is probably right now. But there was some kind of joke that involved being like a male cheerleader and holding the female cheerleader up and having her slide like halfway down your arm, like something like that.
Right.
And me, as he did that joke, going, I can make her talk with like a hand puppet. And
oh, shit.
TJ and his partner lost it. Tim lost it. The audience roared. And I was like, I was just doing that as I turned away because we lost. Oops. Cool. I have power.
powers.
All right.
I think that's about all the time we have. We'd like to, again, thank True Stone Coffee. Woo! If you would like to order some True Stone, go to truestonecoffee.com. Use the promo code apropos.
Or high five, guys.
It's spelled apropos.
And get 10% off your coffee. Booth, get ready to play us out. All I want to do is say thank you to all of the audiences watching in both in the theater.
Happy Die Laughing.
Thank you so very, very much. Hey. Thank you to all the people who joined Apropos of Nothing, the High Five guys, Matt, Lauren down there. They didn't have to do this, but yeah, they did actually.
We were literally paid to do so.
Yeah. He's singling you two out because you're not actually on the podcasts anymore. Yeah.
The only thing we really have to say left. What,
Lauren? We could be eating sandwiches. What do we do?
I know you guys are idiots. The only thing we really have left to say is, eat the fucking cake.
Mm-hmm. Love you.
Podcast selfie. Woo! Yay!
All right, give it up one more time for the AON podcast, everybody. Yay.